Willkommen zu Detective Grimmore, einem Point-and-Click-Adventure, das angeblich sehr, sehr gut, sehr humorvoll sein soll, aber vielleicht ein Ticken kurz. Und ich würde sagen, wir gucken uns das Spiel gemeinsam mal an.
Last night, a murder occurred in a remote part of this swamp. A small tourist attraction, deep within the heart of the marsh.
Hold on. A tourist attraction? Here? I don't get it. Why would anyone come here by choice?
I've explained this already. This area is famous.
Famous? All I read was that some idiot thought they saw an alien here 100 years ago.
Get your facts straight for once. We're talking about a creature that's lived in the swamp for over 60 years.
Okay, so it's a 60-year-old alien. I still don't see why it matters.
If it matters to anyone, it's you. That creature is our prime suspect.
The murder suspect?
That's right. This is no Loch Ness Monster. You need to be taking this seriously.
No, look, come on. How am I supposed to arrest something that might not exist?
You've always enjoyed a challenge before. You can start by reading this.
Our case file? There's not a lot of it, is there?
As usual, we only know the bare essentials at this point.
Oh boy! Das ist der Typ, der jedes Webgame synchronisiert. Und wir haben ihn auch hier. Ansonsten, bitte fragt mich nicht, ich denke, wir hatten in der ersten Cutscene gesehen, dass sie beide im selben Boot saßen und jetzt sind sie in zwei unterschiedlichen gewesen. But oh well. Police file, Richard Remington, founder of tourist attraction Boogie's Bog, was found dead outside his office at 2045 last night. Exact cause of death is unknown, three small wounds to the chest suggest an attack from a clawed creature. Slime around the wound and footprints found at the scene suggests the culprit was Boogie, the legendary swamp creature. Any of the seven other people present in the swamp last night could hold vital information. Page... Ah, okay, das sind einfach nur die Bilder. Fußabdrücke. Das Zeug. Und... Yeah.
Our murder victim, Richard Remington, he was in charge of this, tourist attraction. Boggy's Bog? What a name.
Boggy is the name of our creature. Well, nowadays it is.
You mean that stupid cartoon character? I've heard of him. That thing is our murder suspect?
There's more to Boggy than the cartoon character, I promise you. This is the place it all began. You'll find out soon enough.
Chapter 1, a swamp full of secrets.
Your case file is in the top right.
Okay.
You can look at your clues and suspect profiles in here. When you've collected some, of course. I'll stay and guard our boat, so if you're confused, come back here and I'll help you.
Ich bin eher darüber verwundert, was für Zeug ich hier zur Auswahl habe. 4%, 2%, nichts Prozent. 1, 3? Huh.
That's where I need to go. I can switch to walk mode with the button in the bottom right. Oh, and if I'm feeling confident, I can turn off those sparkly hit icons in the options menu.
No, let's not do that. Obwohl hier das relativ offensichtlich gehalten ist. Sup?
Wow, you didn't get lost yet.
No, I only just got here. Who are you?
You don't remember. Of course, you're not great at remembering. I should be offended, though.
I've never seen you before. You're that weird girl from the fairground. I remember you, but I've been trying to forget. Okay, weiter ist mit der Mitte.
You're that weird girl from the fairground.
Saw your hat blow through here already. You must be slow, if it wouldn't even wait for you.
Well, if you'll let me, I'd better go after it. You can wait here and behave.
You'll get lost. I would never forgive myself if I let you go through without the map.
You have a map of the swamp?
Not anymore. I'm giving it to you.
You should really stay here. It's dangerous. There's been a murder. Although I suppose you know all about it already?
They're saying it was the creature. But it can't be him. He doesn't seem like a killing sort of creature. Nope. He's a different sort of creature.
Wait, what do you mean? If you... she disappeared.
Ich sah sie da gerade eben aber noch.
I might pretend I imagined her.
Okay.
It's an old statue of Boggy. His feet are hidden in a bucket of murky water. Just an odd old tree. It's an opportunity for a photographic memento. The two characters are an explorer and Boggy himself. Are they... fighting?
Notecase file updated. Mhm. Das bedeutet, wenn ich jetzt hier oben... War das da oben oder war das hier? Ich habe noch nicht ganz verstanden, wie das Ganze hier aufgebaut ist. Murder victim. Vielleicht wird sich das über die Zeit erklären.
I still don't quite understand why we have a tourist attraction here. Don't forget to use walk mode to move around.
Yeah, danke.
Just my luck, the gate's closed. Looks like I can move these metal latches around. I should just have to slide at least one of them out of the bottom of the lock. Then I'll be able to get through this gate. Probably.
Okay. So, wo ist der Witz dahinter? Lass mich raten, das macht es jetzt schwerer, das hochzuziehen? Okay, das ist vermutlich der Witz.
Hey, nice. I might get one of these from my office. This is the tourist attraction?
Nichts hier ist eine tourist attraction.
The whole thing just doesn't make sense to me. Let's do some thinking.
Alright.
Drag any two stray thoughts into those slots at the bottom. And flick through the connecting statements in between to make a sentence. Tap the confirm button to try it out.
Yeah, tap, tap.
I just have to focus my thoughts and reach a conclusion. Boggy's bog seems like the middle of nowhere.
Yeah. It's too stupid. It's far too remote for... Isn't warm enough, is way too big for. The swamp is far too remote for tourist attraction, yeah? To make any money.
The swamp is far too remote for the tourist attraction to make any money. It's really bugging me. What's the story behind this place?
Hat das jetzt was gebracht?
There's a hollow part of the tree, right at the front, but it's too dark to see inside.
Okay, dann brauchen wir also Licht. Deine Lichtquelle.
Apparently, there's a museum to the left and a cafe to the right. I'm not hungry, though. This place is putting me off food.
Hint, hint, geh die andere Richtung. Alles klar. Hint, hint, hier ist nicht viel.
Looks like this path leads towards the northwest corner of Boggy's Bog. I can't wait. A rather prominent tree stump looming over the wooden pathway. It's hard to ignore. There's a narrow path here leading up that hill and through the trees. It doesn't look inviting. I'm not sure it's part of the tourist attraction.
Was auch immer daran jetzt geupdatet worden ist, es klang wie noch 15 Satz.
Rocks sitting in the water like stepping stones. If that was a natural occurrence, it's a very convenient one. There's a narrow path here leading up that hill and through the trees. It doesn't look inviting. I'm not sure it's part of the tourist attraction.
Uh-huh. A Okay, wir können also da hoch und da lang.
I should visit the crime scene before I do it. I think Officer James said it was to the west.
Du sagtest, du willst nichts essen.
I should visit the crime scene. I think Officer James said it was to the west.
Okay. Also das war schon richtig. Nur weiter nach Westen gehen. Okay, da tot, da Fußabdrücke, Fußabdrücke, aber auch von normalen Schuhen.
I don't like it here. What's this? There's a lockpick dropped amongst the weeds down here in the water. I just have to work out which vine to break and tap that button.
Sure thing. Ist natürlich jetzt die Frage, welche Richtung man begeben sollte. Das Ende, okay.
That's the one. But I wonder where this lockpick came from.
Lockpick discarded near the entrance of Remington's office. Schön, dass du es bereits weißt, was das ist. Covered in a strange liquid slime, most likely used by the murderer to break into Remington's office. Dann gibt es noch zwei weitere. Und... Map of the attraction generously donated by the mysterious little girl at the entrance. When I'm exploring the swamp, I can access my map from the map. Okay. Button in the corner. Da sehen wir so eine gewisse Übersicht. Okidok. Dann gehen wir erstmal hier hin.
I can't get in here without a key. And I don't feel like kicking the door down. Maybe if I get desperate later on. It's Remington's office. I don't really want to go inside. But I don't think I have a choice. So, this is where they found Remington's body.
Was wurde jetzt hier dran angepasst? Outside, exactly unknown, slime around the wound, badum, any other seven height weiter. Das hatten wir eigentlich alles schon.
There's an open window above Remington's body. One of the curtains is ripped and hanging on the outside.
Okay, das hätte ich dir jetzt nicht sagen können. Das sieht einfach nur aus wie, hey, Fenster offen lassen, weil der da runter plumps ist. Und das ist einfach nur im Wind wehend, aber dass es da gerissen sein soll. Ich vertraue dir einfach mal. So, meine Frage ist, haben wir ein Inventar, wo wir jetzt den Lockpick erneut nutzen sollen? Ich meine, das ist, glaube ich, rein Option, genau.
I can't get in here. Maybe.
Okay, okay. Also, damit haben wir es so ein bisschen erkundet. Wissen das. Können wir hier irgendwie...
I don't like... The strange foot... Maybe I should take a closer look. Maybe I can move some of them out of the way.
Okay, also ich hatte vorhin schon auf die versucht eigentlich auf die Footprints zu klicken und jetzt wo ich dann einfach auf irgendein Stück Gras geklickt habe, hat er das dann wieder gefunden. So, was soll muss ich jetzt hier machen? Also das Zeug aus dem Weg, weil
a strange pair of green flippers badly hidden in the reeds outside the office.
Okay, wie auch immer ich die jetzt angeblich gefunden habe. Aber das sollte schon so ein bisschen darauf hinweisen, dass diese Kreatur vielleicht nicht Boogie das Monster sein könnte.
There are bizarre footprints with three toes leading up to the office door and back down into those reeds by the water.
Ja, okay, also wenn man noch Gummistiefel hat und weiß ungefähr wie tief das ist, dann ist es natürlich eigentlich oder sollte keine Herausforderung sein.
There are bizarre and back.
Okay.
I can't, maybe.
Okay, also man sieht, das ist hier so eine ganz grobe Area. Okay, dann gehen wir wieder. Okay. Sicherheitshalber einfach nochmal das hier macht.
Some suspects. Let's get this investigation started. Alright, let's see. Another suspect for my notebook.
That's a little rude.
No, I'm sorry, did I say that bit out loud?
Maybe not. Maybe I can hear your thoughts.
So would you be able to answer my questions before I asked you?
Would you be able to question my answers before I tell you?
I could try.
I'm Bobby Burl, professional cameraman. Pleased to meet you.
I'm Detective Grimoire. I'm here to investigate last night's murder. Obviously.
Grimoire. Strange. Is that your first name?
It's my 23rd name, but it's the one I like the best. First name? What's the first name? It's my second name. Detective is my first name, haha.
It's my second name. Detective is my first name.
What the fuck is this? What should I talk about? Sachen, die wir einfach noch nicht wissen. Present a clue, present a profile.
So you already told me what you do, but now, why would a cameraman be working here?
I go where I'm needed. Vincent wanted to come to the swamp, and I was happy to help.
Vincent Vanderpeer? You mean that man standing on that rock over there?
That's right. I've worked with him for many years.
Is he your boss?
Oh, I don't know about that. We work together. He's tried to film here before, but he never got permission until about a week ago.
Oh, really? But why did you want to come here in the first place?
If you're looking for a reason to write down in your notebook, I'm sure he can tell you if you ask him. I'm just the guy who carries around the camera.
You always carry that camera with you?
Most of the time.
Okay, viele Clues bekommen, die sich einfach nicht wirklich als wichtig ansehen, aber gut.
You were here yesterday, I presume? Last night?
Yes, I was.
Here, in this clearing?
No, I was over at the cafe getting something to eat. Richard Remington was there too.
Remington? You saw him last night? Just before the murder?
That's right, I saw him. He left the cafe looking rather ill. I offered to help, but he just wanted to go back to his office. He looked like he had a lot on his mind.
He was ill yesterday?
Perhaps it was something he ate.
Okidok. Ich wüsste jetzt nicht, was wir ihm da so entgegenwerfen sollten ansonsten, aber wir können meine... Hier können wir mal gucken. Ob wir denn hier irgendwas haben. Was passiert, wenn ich ihm das hier sage?
You should ask someone else.
Okay, simpel.
Try showing it to somebody different.
Okay. Dachte, ich könnte so vielleicht mehr Informationen bekommen. Hey, was denkst du über Boogie Monster? Hey, was denkst du über Remington? Oh. Okay.
Yes, do you have a message for me?
No, I don't think so.
Then why are you here? I'm incredibly busy.
You don't look it. Who are you anyway?
What a question. You're serious? I am Vincent Vanderpeer.
The famous movie director?
The artist, the visionary, the auteur. I'm a man of many talents.
Let's hope you have a talent for answering my questions. That's a very talented beard you've got, at least. I heard your work was going downhill lately. Nope.
That's great. Let's hope you have a talent for answering my questions.
You're in my light. Could you take a few steps back, please?
But then I'd be too far away to talk to you.
I know.
Can anyone just walk in here and start filming?
My eyebrows. Hey, das Ghost-Dings von diesem Spiel, das nicht wirklich gut ist. Birdie Camera. Has always had a permission from Forced, offered to help. Only recently got permission to film here in the swamp.
Vincent Vanderpeer only recently got permission from Richard Remington to film here in the swamp. I wonder if Mr. Vanderpeer has been breaking rules. Or maybe he'll have an excuse.
The challenge topic will now be available when talking to Vincent. Find the truth. Challenge unlocked, wasn't given permission to film in the swamp. Okay. Wo ich gerade eben gelogikt habe, dass er permission bekommen hat. Who knows? So, kann ich jetzt mit dem nochmal reden? Challenge unlocked.
I heard this isn't the first time you've tried to film here.
Where? In the swamp? What are you talking about?
Remington has denied you the filming permission in the past. Wie auch immer wir das im Endeffekt wissen könnten. You tried to film here before, but the camera broke. Woher willst du das auch wiederum wissen? Remington never found out about your previous attempts. Wissen wir eigentlich alles nicht, um wirklich das behaupten zu können. Remington has denied you. Versuchen wir das.
Remington has denied you the filming permission in the past.
Oh, that? Nothing but the natural process of being in a profession like mine. Every situation simply requires the right approach before the gears start turning smoothly. You understand, I'm sure.
Why did Remington not want you filming here? And why did he change his mind?
It wasn't even up to him. This area is protected, you know. There are certain rules, certain regulations. I encounter this kind of thing all the time, really.
That doesn't explain why he changed his tune. It's a little suspicious.
Why would you say that?
A famous movie director suddenly gets his way. I wonder how that happened. Time to use my notebook. Just drag an item onto the paper to draw the idea.
Money.
Right, that's the one. I think you bribed Remington to get the filming rights.
Well, bribe is a strong word. It was just a little arrangement between friends. Nothing worth getting upset about. I simply promised him a cut of my next movie's profits. It made sense, since he owned the area anyway. Just a favor for a favor.
So you would have owed him money?
Only a small percentage, simply out of courtesy. And not for a long time, either.
Okay, damit haben wir...
I heard the...
Okay, also... Wir können drauflegen, obwohl wir das schon geschafft haben. Machen wir die beiden Sachen.
What's a famous guy like you doing in a place like this?
Quiet. I'm sure you're thinking, why doesn't he send an assistant? But that's not the way this director works.
But what are you doing?
I'm feeling, I'm experiencing, I'm discovering. This area, the history, the atmosphere, it's the perfect setting for my next film. I'm on a scouting mission to get to know this swamp before I begin work on the latest masterpiece in a string of masterpieces.
You're making a movie about Boggy? About the swamp creature?
Of course. He's a fascinating individual, isn't he? So mysterious.
No idea. I haven't met him yet. Is that your cameraman over there?
Yes, that's right. Bobby Burl, my faithful right-hand man. Well, faithful enough, you know.
No, I don't know.
He's an expert cameraman. Really knows his trade, of course. But he gets a bit muddled when it comes to priorities.
Like how? You mean he's lazy? He doesn't look lazy. He looks a bit scary.
Oh no, nothing of the sort. He just has a little hobby that sometimes distracts him from his work. But I wouldn't want anyone else shooting for me.
Were you working yesterday? Here in the swamp, I mean?
Indeed I was working. Very hard indeed. Well into the night.
Hard work, is it? Getting to know the swamp?
You jest. But yesterday I was getting even more involved than usual, yes. Difficult to comprehend, I know.
So what kind of work were you doing?
Well, I was, unable to find my faithful cameraman last night. He had hidden himself quite completely from view.
Bobby Burl, right? Did you need him to film for you?
Always. But being a resourceful type of man, I stepped up and took on the responsibility myself. I was filming in this exact area, in fact.
You were filming? Last night? Here?
Yes, at the time of the murder, I believe. But wait, I know what you're thinking. Now don't forget, I'm not here to shoot some experimental documentary. I have no interest in late-night surveillance footage.
Did you see anything at all? What is it you were filming?
The water. I was filming the water. It's a fascinating subject, one that has me captivated to the point where
So, you didn't see anything useful? Got excited there for a minute.
Nothing useful to you, my good detective. But there are some odd sounds on the audio track. Nothing but wild animals going about their nighttime rituals, I'm sure.
Pump.
Is there something I should ask the cameraman?
Cameraman? Ich habe keine Ahnung, auf was wir hinarbeiten sollen. Ich finde es eh interessant halt, was für Auswahlmöglichkeiten wir haben. Vincent van der Peer told me that Barbie Ball? Was so useless? Was nowhere to be found last night. Was the murderer came to him? Das ist so das Einzige, was mir so auffällt, aber das haben wir doch gerade eben. Is there something I should ask the cameraman? Ich probiere das einfach mal und guck, was dabei rumkommt.
Vincent Van Der Peer told me that Bobby Burl was nowhere to be found last night. Simple enough. What was Mr. Burl doing last night that meant he couldn't help out his boss?
Warum auch immer wir das S freischalten jetzt mussten. Okay, den Hans Hammer. Film-Footage. Footage recorded last night at the exact time of the murder filmed by Vincent Van Der Peer in the clearing on the west side of the swamp near the crime scene. Ja, da, wo wir im Endeffekt ausstehen. There's nothing to see, but various clues can be heard on the audio track. Listen to them in order. Das, da, 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 okay. Ich hab schon aufgehört zu klicken. Das klingt wie ein Stabbing Noise. Das klingt, als würde man gegen eine Holztür klopfen oder Holz allgemein. Das klingt wie der Steg. Das klingt schon so, als wäre er aus dem Fenster geplumpst. So, du. Du Daumen. Gucken wir mal.
I heard from Mr. Van Der Peer over there that you were nowhere to be found last night.
Didn't I say I was at the cafe?
Yeah, you did. But your director needed you for some filming, and he couldn't find you. What were you doing that was so important?
Well, let's see. After I ate, I had a walk around the swamp. I didn't have my camera, so I was free to stretch my legs for once.
Where was your camera? Don't you carry it around with you all the time?
No, not all the time.
It was broken and being repaired at that point. How do you fucking know? You lost it in the swamp and went to look for it. You left it with Van Der Peer and he used it instead, yeah.
You left it with Van Der Peer, and he used it instead that night.
That's right, he was looking after that camera. So I went for a late night stroll. This place is beautiful in the evenings.
You just walked around? You didn't do anything? Didn't see anyone?
Well, I can't say that. I have various ways to pass the time, you know.
Swamp Humper, Van Der Peer said you had a hobby on the side. You were collecting samples of swamp water. What? You got lost in the swamp and were trying to get out.
Van Der Peer said you had a hobby on the side.
Is that what he said? Well, yes, he's right. I brought two cameras with me when I came here. I left my video camera, yes. But I have another one. It's much smaller, and it only takes black and white photographs. You know the kind I mean?
A really old one?
Yes, I suppose so. I've always enjoyed traditional photography, and this place is a wonderful opportunity to take some pictures of a natural environment.
So, you were having some time off to take black and white photographs? For fun?
Only one photograph. You have to be disciplined when you're not using a digital camera.
Can I see it?
Of course. I took it near the woods at the back of the swamp. It's quite an interesting shot, but the light qualities weren't perfect. Here we are. Feel free to take a look.
Wait, what? This is a photo?
Mm-hmm. I haven't developed it yet. I only took it last night. Just brush the developing fluid over the photo to reveal the image.
Oh, cool. Oh, no. It's a dude in a costume. The Boogie Monster.
What? Is that Boggy? The swamp creature just standing in the water?
It could be. Personally, I'm not convinced, but I'll let you decide for yourself.
Yeah, it's totally the monster. A blurry photograph taken by Bobby Burl shortly before the murder. It shows something that looks like a boogie in the woods at the back of the swamps. The being in the photo seems to have long legs. Mm-hmm. Okay, dann haben wir das erstmal soweit. Ja, der Kollege steht natürlich aus irgendeinem Grund gepflegt im Wasser, um seine Beine, also Länge der Beine ein bisschen zu vertuschen. Und, weißt du was, ich gehe ganz bewusst nochmal hoch, einfach um zu gucken, ob hier nochmal irgendwas sich geändert hat. Ja, okay. Dann würde ich sagen, da lang. Einfach mal um zu gucken. Hier ist jetzt das Museum. Okay, hier ist was am Leuchten.
I don't think it's a window, but this hatch is shut at the moment. I can't see inside. This side of the museum is surrounded by blue and red flowers.
Interessant.
I don't think it's a window, but this side.
Okay, das gehört dazu.
It's a stepping stone path that goes past the museum and into the woods. So glad I'm wearing my best shoes today. That's the logo for Boggy's Bog. So, I'm guessing this museum is an official part of the tourist attraction. I hope they don't charge an entrance fee.
Yeah, weil das ja jetzt so relevant ist.
That museum is... Which makes it look even more out of place in a swamp. Is it being held up on wooden supports? It's bizarre.
Kann ich da rein?
The door's jammed unless I can get these brass handles out of the way. Seems like I can rotate them around, just until the gap in the middle is clear. That top hat guy would have so struggled with this one.
Sup, nerd?
I'd better take a look at this. This journal, it's full of drawings and notes all about Boggy.
Was eine Überraschung in einem Museum über Boggys Borg.
It seems to be the centerpiece of the entire museum.
Journal recorded 60 years ago by explorer who first visited the swamp. The only record of Boggy existed contains notes and sketches of on the appearance of the swamp creature. Boggy is shown with three small claws on each arm. Boggy's feet are always hidden in the water. There seems to be a page ripped from the back. Oh.
Let's see here. This journal belonged to the explorer who first discovered Boggy in this swamp 60 years ago. Models of Boggy's claws. Hold on. What's this? Something doesn't seem right here. I think I should try arranging these models into pairs. Something seems out of place.
Das sind Tentakel, ja. Example based on sketches. Ach so, die sind fake.
I don't think these gloves are part of the exhibit. Looks like someone tried to hide them here.
Ich muss erst mal gucken, was es überhaupt wollte, bis ich dann gesehen habe, dass hier diese Kästen mit Exempel A und B am Start sind. Alright. These flippers, they are not part of the museum exhibit. That's for sure.
There's a little door in the wall here. I think it leads outside. It's locked, though.
Ja, weil der Dorfuß davor sitzt, natürlich.
Some educational facts about swamps. Did you know swamps are gross? Yes? Yes, I did. Apparently the museum was founded by the explorer many years ago, in a different location. It's only recently been moved here to be part of the tourist attraction.
Moved? Wow.
That might explain why it looks so out of place.
That's beeindruckend.
Apparently, this is the exact hat worn by the explorer 60 years ago. It seems everyone is destined to lose a hat or two in this damn swamp.
So, du.
Let me guess, you don't work here, do you? I wonder if that makes you the first tourist I've seen today.
You're incorrect, detective. I am no mere tourist.
How did you know I was a detective? Was it my stylish trench coat? My sensitive, inquisitive manner?
It was the clueless expression on your face.
What are you talking about?
Yeah, that's the one.
Right. That's it. You've done it now. What's your name?
I go by Folder. Agent Folder. What are you doing?
I'm writing bad things about you in my notebook. I'm doing a drawing of your beautiful face. I'm writing in my diary. It's been a long day.
I'm writing in my diary. It's been a long day.
So, dann haben wir jetzt diesen Kollegen mit der Tomblernase. Jojo.
So, if you're not a tourist, and you don't work here...
I am a scholar, an academic. I'm here to research the past and uncover the future.
So, you're visiting the museum. For fun.
Fun! There's nothing so simple as fun to be had here. I come to this museum night and day to study its secrets.
Ah, what kind of secrets? It's just a museum about Boggy, right? The swamp creature.
He's one of the most intriguing modern examples of cryptozoology. A fascinating combination of scientific fact and wild speculation.
I'm with you on the speculation front. Although, come to think of it, people have been hinting that I should find out about the history of this creature.
A wise suggestion. And you've come to the right person. My knowledge far exceeds anyone else you might have met so far.
So, you'll help me?
I suppose I could divulge some of my findings with you. If you're in the mood for a little light reading, let me find it for you. Oh yeah, this'll do. Something for beginners, at least.
Oh Gott, der Typ nervt mich jetzt schon. Information about Boogie collected by Agent Fowler. Boogie Swamp became a protected area after reports of hunting in the area. Boogie's appearance has changed from the original sketches in which he has three claws on each arm. In which he has him. The modern character has simply fin-like arms instead to make him less threatening. Yeah. No footprints were recorded in the journal, but some experts believe that information is out there somewhere. Yep. Last night.
So, Mr. Folder.
Agent Folder.
Yeah. Were you here yesterday? What were you doing last night?
I was here, in the museum. Going through my files one final time before disappearing into the night.
Don't museums usually close in the evenings?
They do. I've never been one to worry about other people's schedules. I come and go as I please. There's a key to every lock, Detective.
Oh, so you have the key to the museum?
Of course I don't. Why would you think that?
Well, I...
Once again, that clueless expression. I use a lockpick and get in through the small side door. I have a right to be here, you see. Remington has no business locking me out, so I don't let him.
You just admitted to breaking the law. If everyone did that, my job would be a lot easier.
It's not my best lockpick. This new one's cheap. I used to own one, a superior model. Unfortunately, I misplaced it in one of the darker corners of the swamp, so I don't...
I'm writing down your confession about sneaking around here at night.
And what are you gonna do? Report me to Remington? Good luck, my friend.
I need to pick my questions carefully.
Die Sache mit dem Lockpick ist natürlich Stop Swamping the Swamp. My Lost Head taucht auch jedes Mal wieder auf. The Gift Shop, das wir auch bisher noch nicht gesehen hatten. The Treehouse, auch keine Ahnung. And I was given by... I found inside, I found near. The Lockpick, I found near... Near... Remington's body might belong to Mr. Harper. Who the fuck is Mr. Harper? Might belong to Agent Folder.
The lockpick I found near Remington's body might belong to Agent Folder. As far as I know, Agent Folder is experienced with lockpicks. I wonder if he's hiding something.
Okay, dann haben wir das Freischalten. The lockpick was found outside the scene. Okay, good, yeah.
I have a bone to pick with you.
Are you setting yourself up for a joke? Something about a lockpick?
Maybe. Who knows? Stop distracting me. I'm trying to interrogate you.
My apologies. Go ahead.
So, what are we showing Folder now?
Present a clue. Den Lockpick eigentlich, ne? Alles andere wäre ja weniger relevant, oder?
Where did I find this again?
Oh, come on, game. Oh, God, outside office.
I found a lockpick at the scene of the crime.
Oh, apparently you did. Why does this concern me?
You said Remington always carried a lockpick? No. You already admitted to owning a lockpick and using it to open doors. You were at the scene at the moment, might know who... No.
You already admitted to owning one of these, and how you're ever so happy to come and go as you please with it, am I right? Be honest.
Luckily for me, Detective, I was honest with you. I believe I have already explained that second lockpick before you even found it.
You lost your lockpick in the swamp and had to buy a new one. You let Mama home. You left your lockpick by Remington's office yesterday.
You lost your lockpick in the swamp and had to buy a new one.
That's right. I appreciate you finding it for me. However, I won't ask for it back. Apparently, it has since become some diabolical instrument in the art of murder.
Yeah, it's an important piece of evidence.
Okay, das hat mir jetzt nicht wirklich weitergeholfen. Okay. Damit haben wir das auch abgeschlossen. Ich will jetzt mal gucken. Jetzt haben wir hier... You're incorrect, Detective. I'm no mere tourist. Keine Ahnung, was mir die Dinger immer noch sagen sollen. Ah, das sind suspicious Sachen. Mhm. Leute, tap to change.
Not suspicious. Suspicious.
Ah, wir sollen also damit selber bestimmen, was Sache ist. Aber warum haben wir hier 5? Ah, es ist auf mehrere Seiten. Hier gibt es also noch jeweils 2 weitere, oder hier gibt es noch 3 Instant, die wir freischalten können. Natürlich ist es suspicious, suspicious. Suspicious definitiv ebenfalls. Das ist vielleicht uninteressant, aber halt. Das ist natürlich wichtig. Also der ist doch bisher der offensichtlichste in der Hinsicht. Ich muss zugeben, ich muss natürlich auch mal die anderen angucken. Der Kollege hat zum Beispiel 7 Sachen. Research Location for a movie about Boogie. Okay, von mir aus. Works with things is not suspicious when unable to find. Das könnte man theoretisch als suspicious ansehen. Das weiß ich jetzt auch nicht, warum das suspicious sein
soll. Not suspicious!
Damn. Was swimming at the exact time. Natürlich, das ist suspicious. Obwohl, man könnte sagen, er hätte da ja solch ein Alibi. Tried to film, but wasn't given permission. Das ist wiederum. Das ist mit der String of popular fantasy movies.
Not suspicious.
Also man kann auch hier über die Seite klicken. Cameraman has worked with for years.
Not okay. Suspicious.
Carries a camera around most of the time.
Not suspicious.
Dass wir mitbekommen haben.
Not suspicious.
Das werden wir mal lassen. Enjoys additional black and white photography.
Not suspicious.
Und das ist suspicious. Body was found outside his office in the swamp. Das stimmt zumindest. Received 3 small wounds. Mysterious. Ja, das ist Tatsache aktuell, nicht unbedingt. Was discovered 60 years ago by an explorer. Von mir aus. Was recorded in the explorer's journal. Okay, von mir aus. Has not been officially cited for 60 years. Okay, von mir aus. Has 3 claws on each arm. Ja, okay, von mir aus. Und his appearance changed from the original records. Ja, bei mir aus. Also bisher ist das so, yo, das ist das, was wir wissen. Okay, der Arsch blockiert die Dings. Die Tür, wo vermutlich Sachen für hinter versteckt werden. Wir müssen vermutlich dann irgendwie da irgendwann da durchklettern. Ich würde sagen, wir gehen einfach mal weiter.
The water's clear here. I can see my reflection in it. Not bad. This staircase is a tree. And this tree's a staircase. And this place is so weird.
Uh-huh.
What's this? Looks like the stuff in the water has been moved around recently.
Wie kannst du das... Never mind.
Maybe if I reposition them, I'll find a clue.
Ach so, hier ist ein Ding. Okay. Willst du mir noch hier erzählen, oder? Ich versuche jetzt hier gerade erstmal zu realisieren, was was ist. Oh Gott, ich habe hier so viel Zeug und gefühlt ist davon alles irgendwie zwar wichtig, aber merkwürdig von der Anordnung. Okay, lass mich nochmal gucken. Gibt es hier noch irgendwas? Es gibt diesen Stein. Es gibt dieses Blatt. Ich hätte jetzt gesagt, das ist so. Das ist so vielleicht. Das wäre dann so wiederum. Deswegen weiß ich so überhaupt nicht, was es soll. Ja, das Blatt ist halt merkwürdig. Was ich nicht weiß, was das sollen, sind die hier. Das sieht aus wie der Äußerste, aber halt falsch irgendwie gedreht, you know? Das ist aber so passend. Ja, es sieht so aus, als wäre das eher so die äußere Seite, aber halt. Genau, als wäre das so gedacht, aber. Das passt halt so überhaupt nicht. Achso, wenn man das vielleicht so ein bisschen näher platziert, aber so. Man sagt, das ist halt so. So, hier haben wir noch einen kleinen und weiter. Müssen wir ganz kurz einfach mal bewegen. Es sieht eigentlich super simpel aus, aber ich habe das Gefühl, dass uns trotzdem halt Sachen fehlen. Ich weiß nicht, was uns dieser Stock hier bringen soll. Ich weiß nicht, wo das ernsthaft hinkommt. Ha, I don't know.
Someone please tell me why there's a house here. Well, the lights are on. Maybe somebody's home.
Also ich würde lieber hier oben wohnen als da unten, sagen wir mal so. Dann geht's hier weiter. Okay. Okay, wir bewegen uns in Richtungen, die ich so nicht vorhatte. Ich will eigentlich nur wissen, wie man da lang geht, wieder runter. Okay, das ist nicht selbstverständlich, weil wenn man hier eine Treppe hochgeht, denkt man, dass man irgendwo einen Pfeil nach unten hätte.
The latch is broken on this door. Seems I can fix it with those three cogs if I just put them in the right place. Once they're on the right pins, I can move the handle at the bottom to try and open the door.
Okay. Okay, das wird dann jetzt schon wieder nicht so funktionieren.
Perfect. I am amazing.
Die hat ein Blatt als Kopf.
The owner of this house seems to enjoy reading. Though, I'm not sure what else there is to do up here, actually. This is like an oven? Or is it just a boiler? It's so old-fashioned, it hurts my brain. There's a whole load of needles and wool on that shelf. Or should I say yarn? I just don't know anymore. A little blanket on a little bed in a little house. It makes very little sense.
Why? Wenn die Person nicht wirklich groß ist, warum sollte das nicht okay sein?
You just walked straight into my house, did you?
No, exactly. You had to climb up here first. I'm afraid to walk into people's house. Sorry, I should have rung the bell.
Sorry, I would have rung the bell, but you don't have one.
Normally, I have methods for dealing with unwanted attention. But I can make exceptions for harmless idiots.
Do you get any attention up here?
Most of the time, people like to leave me alone. But I don't think you're going to, are you?
No. I could make an excuse and say it's my job to ask you about last night, but to be honest, I climbed all the way up here and I just like being indoors.
Well, if you insist on staying, I'll tell you.
I'm Lady Weybridge, and I think you might be climbing up the wrong trees.
I'm Detective Grimoire, and I think I might agree with you. What do you do here? Did you work for Richard Remington?
I was living here before that man was even born. And I have absolutely nothing to do with him, or his little tourist attraction.
You're exaggerating. How long have you been here? Just in this treehouse? What do you do up here?
I've been here longer than anyone. Even longer than... well, anyone.
I like numbers.
60 years, something like that.
What have you been doing for that time? If you don't mind me asking.
I have many reasons to be here, but I won't bore you with all the details of my life.
I'm sure there's one detail worth writing down.
I like to study the plants and flowers in this area. I've learned many things from them.
Now, what about this little chemistry set you've got on your table?
I wouldn't call it a chemistry set, but if you bring me an object that has liquid on it or inside it, I'll tell you what that liquid consists of.
Wow, how do you do that?
Chemistry.
A page from Weybridge's Book of Pressed Flowers contains information about all the flowers in the swamp and all where and where they grow. The green and the red species only grow around the side door of the museum and can't be found anywhere else. Okay, sure.
Your job is to ask me about what happened last night.
Do you even know what happened last night?
I know more than you might imagine.
Oh, that sounds useful. Can you tell me? What were you doing?
I was here, in my house, by myself.
Mm-hmm. What else?
That's it.
Thanks. Just give me a minute to write all this down.
Das ist nicht viel. Haben wir irgendwas, was wir ihr zeigen können? Okay. Ja, bisher war das nicht viel. Dann gehen wir weiter.
Predictably, a trash can. And I just can't resist taking a look inside. The glamorous life of a detective. My favorite part of the job. Maybe there's something underneath the trash in here.
Oh, yay.
Or something more sinister.
Schön, wenn man denkt, man müsste noch weiter graben, um es freizuschalten, und dann geht's auf einmal schon wieder los. Okay. These look like designs for a boogie costume. What's going on around here? Mm-hmm. Wir haben zwei Sachen bereits gefunden.
Are we really talking about a swamp creature here?
No, we fucking do not. This costume design was hidden inside. I found a trash can. Man könnte sagen, hey, so Kostüm, aber halt, das sagt doch überhaupt nichts, dass the Swamp Creature, the Boogie Creature, niemals existiert hatte. Was doing last night? Aber wir haben niemanden, auf den wir uns beziehen können mit der Sache. Is showing me. Achso, I found in the trash can explain, but is showing me.
The costume design I found in the trash can explains what Burl's black and white photo is showing me. My detective's intuition is kicking in. That black and white photograph, I'm not sure I'm looking at the real Boggy here.
and I think these designs I found in the trash can might be the answer. I'll ask around, see if anybody knows anything about this. Oh, and I should start looking for the costume itself. If I can find that, there'll be some pretty impressive evidence.
Chapter 2. Okay, a deadly disguise.
I have something for you.
Another gift already. Where are you keeping all this stuff? You don't even have pockets in that dress.
I don't need a pocket to carry a key.
What key?
I don't know. You could try it on any door you like. Although, I recommend you try it on that office door.
Remington's office?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, Deus Ex Machina Girl ist wieder da gewesen und auch wieder weg. Ne, ich wollte eigentlich nicht
laufen. A trash can. The glamorous.
Okay, ja, das hatten wir und da ist auch nichts Neues dazugekommen. Ich wollte eigentlich auf die Dose daneben klicken. Ich muss ganz ehrlich zugeben, dass ich das eigentlich nicht. Ich frage, ob es wirklich der Office Key sein soll. Ich gehe aber trotzdem ins Museum nochmal. Wir wissen, ob ich die Tür öffnen kann.
There's a little door in the wall here.
Okay, also ich kann nicht einfach hingehen und sagen, hey, benutzt das mal bitte. Damit ist wirklich nur für diese eine Sache.
Even though I have the key, this might not be as simple as I'd hoped. This door has two keyholes. So, which key should I use in each one?
Am I missing something here? So, hier haben wir doch einiges. Meine Güte, ist das creepy.
Remington's desk is covered in drawings and maps and notes. It's all about Boggy. He was obsessed. An ink bottle spilled into his work. I'm sure he didn't do that on purpose. Eesh, it's a bit of a mess. Perhaps there's something underneath those drawings. It's a note addressed to Richard Remington. The handwriting is immaculate. Richard, our man of the world. A little help is in order. We're worried that the efforts regarding our elusive little friend might be in vain. Send word when you can. The letter is signed FF. And attached is a blurry little picture. It's some kind of metallic insect. The whole thing is a mystery. I have no idea. Vincent van der Peer's business card. There's a couple of numbers scribbled on the back. It's a letter Remington was writing before something caused him to spill his ink bottle. My dear fellow, I received your note 2 weeks ago, but have only recently found the time to do the appropriate research on the matter. I feel like my time in this awful swamp might finally come to a close, all due to the simple realization, the rest is obscured. What a tease.
Okay.
It's a letter before okay.
Wollte gucken, ob man das irgendwie noch bewegen kann.
There's a map of the swamp lying on the desk. It's been annotated in a few places.
Das wäre cool, wenn du die vielleicht.
There's a map of the swamp lying. It's been.
Ja, schön, wenn man sich diese halt gekreilt hätte, ne?
It's a the hand Richard where we send the letters and it's some kind of.
Okay, also das, was wir bewegen dürfen. Ist unrelevant. Alles andere.
There's a map of the swamp. It's been.
Nope, das ist nicht mehr Map. Okay.
It's a sharp metal poker for a fireplace, hidden in the shadows. Something about those three prongs. I feel like I just stumbled across an incredibly important piece of evidence.
Fireplace poker hidden in Remington's offices has three small prongs. On the end, there is a small amount of dried blood on the tips of the prong covered in a strange liquid slime. The three prongs match up with Remington's wounds. Could this be the murder weapon? Schön, dass wir sie einfach wieder abstellen.
This is the creepiest office I've ever been in. Ever. Something happened here.
No shit.
There are signs of a struggle between the desk and the window.
an old hunting rifle, discarded carelessly near the window. This isn't the kind of thing I can ignore.
An old-fashioned hunting rifle found discarded on the floor in Ramage's office.
This is the creepiest of...
Okay.
These animals... They're all... They're not... I don't recognize any of them.
You... Also ein paar kann man schon wieder erkennen. Aber es sind definitiv so ein paar, die fragwürdig sind, yep.
Photos and paintings line the wall above the fireplace. But one of the frames is empty. Wait a second. What are these pieces on the floor underneath it? This photo is ripped, but it looks important. If I can piece it together again, maybe it'll reveal a secret.
Okidoki. Immer schön nach den Ecken als erstes suchen. Wie man das bei Jigsaw Puzzles nochmal macht. Okay. Ach schön, wenigstens setze ich das so ein bisschen selber zusammen, wenn man es erstmal halbwegs hat. Nee, das ist nicht der Hut von dem, das ist der Hut von dem. Dem. Wie auch immer das jetzt hier nicht mitspielt. Also. Achso, ist alles leicht versetzt ist. So.
This photograph. It's a young Remington. And then some other men I don't know. They're all holding rifles. Maybe I can ask Harper about it.
Who is Harper? Hunter's headquarters, a group. Photo of hunting group, a young Remington stands among friends. They are all holding rifles. Okidoki, und ich gehe davon aus, dass irgendeiner von, mindestens einer von denen hier auftauchen wird.
Have I uncovered a secret in here?
All the suspects. Murdered the victim, was? A broken mirror, schön, dass wir es noch nicht gefunden haben. Historical evidence that was a ghost, belongs to a secret society? Was found at the crime scene. Ich meine, the hunting rifle, ja. Those footprints? Ich hätte ja verstanden, wenn man einmal gesagt hätte, hey, der Fire Poker wäre das gewesen. Found at the crime scene. This horror story disproves that, explains why shouldn't be the reason the hunting photo isn't, it shouldn't be the reason. Also hier weiß ich wirklich nicht, was ich reinschmeißen soll. The hunting rifle explains why Richard Remington was murdered. Photo was the reason. Remington's desk was the reason. Maybe? Ach so, Dingsbums murderte. All the suspects disprove that. Richard Remington. Also mir fehlt hier so ein bisschen der Sprung, die Logik, warum ich hier angeblich. The hunting photo shouldn't be the reason. Hier kannst du natürlich den größten Blödsinn hinschreiben. Also dadurch, dass wir hier keinen anderen haben, Obwohl, man könnte maximal sagen, the hunting photo shouldn't be the reason or the suspect murdered the victim. Probieren wir mal.
The hunting photo shouldn't be the reason or the suspects murdered the victim. I don't get it. Seriously?
Neither do I, my dude. Those footprints explain why... Nee, the costume design explains why... Was found at the crime scene?
The costume design explains why those footprints was found at the crime scene. Oh, that doesn't...
Wie gesagt, das Problem ist, dass ich jetzt nicht so richtig weiß, have I uncovered an important secret in here? Also was, Ich probier mal das demnächste, ja?
The hunting photo is historical evidence that Richard Remington belonged to a secret society. I'm getting a strong feeling that Remington might be the bad guy in this story. If he wasn't already dead, I would have loved to ask him a couple of questions. I should ask around, see if I can gather any information about his motives for being here.
Okay, also die Logik ging mir so überhaupt nicht in Sinn. Wieso ist jetzt aber mal der Bösewicht? Weil er ein Jäger ist? Hä? Chapter 3, Richard Remington's Real Reasons. Wir haben noch nicht mal alles entdeckt und sind schon bei Kapitel 3.
The open window looks over the wooden planks outside. Oh, and on one side a part of the curtain has been ripped off. The open window... Something happened here. There are signs of a struggle between the...
Das hatten wir.
I don't know what's in that jar, and I wish it wasn't in there. I'm gonna stop looking at it now. This is the creepiest.
Okay, also ich habe das Gefühl, dass wir jetzt hier alles mit gesehen hatten. Was würde ich sagen? Local woman. Over 60 years. Knows all about the flowers that grow here. Hates Remington and his. Das ist suspicious.
Not suspicious!
Beiden klingt zumindest weniger suspicious. Okay, dann gehen wir mal über zu Kaffee. Weil da ist noch ein Typ.
Ah, yes. I heard they were sending somebody over. So you're Detective Grimoire.
At your service. Well, kind of. You're a suspect too.
Of course. Feel free to be as suspicious as you like. I won't be offended. You can call me Harper.
How did you know my name?
I can only assume I must have read about one of your many exploits. But I think you'll find this swamp to be your greatest challenge.
What's so challenging about an old swamp? You mean this murder case? I'm sure I can handle it. I love trying to eat challenge for breakfast.
What's so challenging about an old swamp?
The swamp itself has a history that has captured many imaginations, for better or for worse. My advice to you, look to the past. It could be the way forward.
Oh.
So, you sit in this boat all day and sell food to people? To tourists, I guess?
Not just the tourists, but the employees too. To anyone who is hungry or thirsty. I know everyone's favorite foods.
What are they? Oh, and is this a real shipwreck? How did it get here?
I can't expose all the secrets of the swamp. I don't want to spoil your fun.
Is there a secret to this shipwreck?
No.
You just spoiled my fun.
You'll find out there are some secrets worth keeping when you've worked here as long as I have.
Well, how long is that?
I've worked in the swamp almost as long as Mr. Remington. We knew each other for a long time.
Really? So what was his favorite food?
Mr. Remington enjoyed a specialty only I can make. The bog dog. He ate one nearly every day. A real creature of habit, that one.
It looks like a hot dog.
It's similar. But I'm afraid I have to disappoint you. I'm not serving them today.
Why not?
Yesterday I found this strange green powder in my entire supply.
Guess I'm out of luck today. Well, thanks for the information. You've been a real big help.
Wait, take this with you. If you get thirsty, it's the most popular drink in Boggiesbog. Swamp juice. Try it.
Well, I'll try some later on.
You're in luck. That's my last bottle. A lot of swamp juice has been disappearing from my stock recently. I can only assume I must have been selling them all.
Did something strange happen at the cafe yesterday?
Ich find's interessant, dass da so viele wichtige Sachen hervorgehoben worden sind. Aber dass das grüne Zeug auf diesen Bockdog erschienen ist, war irgendwie scheißegal. So gucken wir mal. Visited the cafe after? Left the cafe feeling ill after? Das ist vielleicht gar nicht falsch. Left the cafe feeling ill after? Harper sold him a bockdog.
Richard Remington left the cafe feeling ill after Harper sold him a bockdog. Harper is basically in charge of all the food and drink here in Boggy's Bog. I'll have to ask him about this.
Wir gehen trotzdem die anderen Sachen vorher durch.
You're going to ask me about what I was doing last night.
I was going to? Were you going to tell me anything?
I was working here at the cafe in the evening. I had a couple customers. Eventually they all left and I locked up and went home.
Do you lock away everything at night?
Not everything, just the storeroom over there.
You mean that little door on the side of the ship? Is there anything else to lock?
I leave the chairs, tables, and trash can where they are. Lifting things like that is not a job for an old man.
Don't you have anyone to help you?
Mr. Remington liked to keep us down to his skeleton staff. There simply aren't many people who would choose to work in a place like this.
A skeleton staff? Well, that's convenient for him, since...
Don't make that joke. I won't laugh.
Okay.
Someone made a costume to look like the creature. They must have known it would get reaction for sure. But I wonder if they planned things to go this far.
When you're finished theorizing, I was going to show you these sketches I found in the trash can right next to your cafe.
It does seem like someone was designing a costume. A disguise, perhaps?
I don't know.
Try to think why somebody would do such a thing.
I don't know.
What could they achieve with it?
I don't know!
Not yet.
You said you knew Remington?
He and I knew each other for a long time. I came to work at his tourist attraction in the early days, when he needed help.
Well, what kept you here?
I know most people wouldn't want to work in a place like this. I actually like it here, so I was happy to oblige.
You might like it, but I still don't see why anyone would build a tourist attraction here.
Mr. Remington has his reasons. He probably had several. I don't presume to know what they all were. Even though we were friends, he had some secrets, some hobbies, that I was happy to let him keep secret.
Secrets? Hobbies? A secret hobby?
He was a man with a dream, I can tell you that much.
Uh-huh.
I was told Remington left the cafe looking ill last night. Since you seem to be completely in charge of all the food and drink around here, I'm afraid this is something I can't ignore.
He was an old man. His health wasn't perfect. But I'm not arguing with you. I think it is suspicious. What do you think caused it?
What do I think caused it?
Das Zeug, was da drauf gesprinkelt worden ist.
A bog dog he ate at the cafe gave him food poisoning.
I keep all my food locked in the storeroom when I'm not here. You think he was poisoned?
I think he was poisoned.
Poisoned by me?
The storeroom was broken into with a lockpick. You left food outside the storeroom.
The storeroom was broken into with a lockpick.
A lockpick? I've never encountered a problem like this before. But since last night, am I in a position to doubt a claim like that?
Somebody knew that Remington would eat a bog dog. He ate one every day, right?
Do you suppose this explains the missing bottles of swamp juice as well?
Yes, it does. Feels like I'm done talking to him. Oh, das ist mir noch nie aufgefallen. Ich weiß ja nicht, ob die bei den anderen auftauchen. So, in the Boggy's Bog, has the appearance of strange liquid slime, da werden wir das gleich zu der Eulen da bringen. Harper says a lot of swamp juice has disappeared from the stock recently. Ich warte nur darauf, dass die ganzen Slime-Dinger, die da, oder Slime-Wunden, einfach nur das Zeug sind. So. Present the clue. Hier ist ziemlich viel am Tropfen.
Let's see. First thing we do is put the sample of liquid into the cauldron, then tap the faucet. And now, we just have to match the color of that liquid with these ingredients. Got it! Now I know what that liquid consists of. I'll write it down in my notes.
Ich hab mir da irgendwie was anderes drunter vorgestellt, aber gut.
I found these designs for a Boggy costume. Do you know anything about them?
You're asking me because you can tell I'm experienced with needlecraft and sew my own clothes?
No, but that's a good reason. Let's go with that.
Well, these designs look like they should have stayed where they were.
In the trash?
On paper.
Oh, how come?
Whoever drew them didn't really know what they were doing.
You would have done it differently?
Of course. I am a seamstress. There was a time when I considered sewing my craft. My livelihood.
Really?
When Richard Remington arrived in the swamp years ago, I offered him some of my handmade fabric as a peace offering. I don't think he cared much for it. Most likely he threw it away. A pointless gift from some strange woman.
Maybe not all that wrong.
You've been here so long, you must have crossed paths with Remington a few times. What did you think of him?
That man was a threat to the swamp. We'll be better off without him. Hopefully the curtain will fall on his little tourist attraction as well.
Better off? With a killer on the loose now?
There have been murderers loose in the swamp before.
What are you talking about?
In my time here, I've seen the swamp invaded by men. By hunters. Several times. They're relentless.
What were they hunting? Wait, what about Boggy? Is that why no one has seen him in 60 years?
They always fell short of their ultimate goal. That just meant they came back again and again, doing more harm each time.
But this area is protected by law, right?
It is now. But some men have no respect for laws, of any kind. They tried to get me to leave my home here. I stood my ground.
Obviously. But this whole area is a tourist attraction now. I doubt Remington would have allowed anyone to march into Boggy's Bog with a gun and start hunting down his main attraction.
Du weißt doch bereits selber, was Sache ist.
I recognize some of those men. Unfortunately, they've hunted in the swamp before.
Before it became a protected area?
Before that, yes. And one of them after that.
Okay. Was hilft mir?
I have nothing good to say about that man, so I won't say anything at all. I'm not even sure who that is.
Okay, also die Dame weiß vermutlich so einfach nichts. Okay. She's been here a long time.
Let's see. First thing we do is put the sample of liquid, then tap the faucet. And now... Got it! Now I know what that liquid consists of. I'll write it down and... that looks pretty similar to last time.
Ja, okay, also das ist die Tatsache. Die nutzen alle den gleichen Spaß.
Let's see. First, then tap the...
Das ist also tatsächlich immer das Zeug.
Got it. Now I know what that... I'll write it down. Hmm. This was the exact...
Yes.
Let's see. First, then tap... And now...
Yes, yes, yes.
Got it. Now I... All right, what's going... That was definitely the...
Yep. Okay, damit wissen wir also, was Sache ist. Die haben alles gleiche genutzt und... Ich meine, wir können hier gerne nochmal die Hunting Rifle zeigen.
You can put that away. I can't help you with it.
Okay, sicher, sicher.
No, thank you.
Okay, dann würde ich sagen, wir gehen zum Café über und bewegen uns von hier aus weiter. Dann kommen wir nämlich zum Gift Shop.
It's a humble gift shop wagon. Let's take a look.
Oh boy. Okay.
Bonky dolls, bonky toys, bonky postcards. Yeah, this stuff isn't half bad.
Says you.
What on earth? This... thing doesn't seem to belong here at all. It's some kind of roughly made costume head, I think. There's a strange piece of red fabric stuffed inside. Two clues for the price of one, I guess.
Okay, und schön wieder zurückgestellt.
Boggy doll. It's a framed drawing of Boggy. What a shame, it's not even signed. It's a map of the swamp. Mine seems a little older than this one, though. It's a photo of the swamp entrance. Or it could be a painting. There's really no way to tell, you know? Well, I wouldn't wear it. Maybe to sleep in, you know, not outside. A Boggy's Bog Mug. Maybe I'll get one and surprise Officer James for Christmas.
Okay. Happy is from a homemade boggy costume found hidden amongst the hats in the gift shop. Has an unusual lining with a red swirly pattern. The red lining was a piece ripped from some curtain. Okay.
Sorry to interrupt. I can see that you're hard at work.
You weren't here yesterday.
Oh no, I only just arrived, and now I was in my office yesterday. Did you miss me?
Oh, no, I only just arrived.
You're the detective, right?
I'm a detective.
So, that was your hat I saw blowing through here.
You spotted it too.
If you're good at your job, you may have realized that it's kinda dead around here. So, I generally notice magical floating detective hats. Oh, and don't worry. You look better without it.
How do you know?
Oh, I have a good imagination.
Uh-huh.
I didn't expect to see someone your age working in a place like this. But then again, I didn't expect there to be a place like this in a place like this.
I only started working here this year anyway. It's temporary. Just running the gift shop to earn a little extra money. Don't ask how I ended up here.
I'll save that question for a different day. You don't seem at home here, exactly.
I hate it. This place is disgusting.
Come on, you don't think it's kind of beautiful?
You would say that. You only just got here. You'll get sick of it.
If I wasn't here, I'd be stuck in my office doing paperwork.
At least at your office, you don't have to bring spare clothes every day. It's impossible to leave this place without being covered in dirt.
Challenge accepted. When you have a moment free from your busy schedule, I need to ask you about last night.
I know, but it won't help. I worked here during the day, then left my gift shop and went home in the evening, same as every day.
You just leave your gift shop here when you go?
No, I put it in my pocket.
Yeah, seriously though, as much as I appreciate sarcasm, I think I'd get in trouble if I wrote something like that down in my notes.
Well, look, you've noticed the gift shop has wheels, and you're thinking, oh, she's pretty lazy to leave it lying around. But if you want to try pushing this thing through the swamp, be my guest. And I can't lock it up, so I just leave it here overnight. Nobody's ever stolen any of this lousy merchandise anyway. I even left my spare clothes here when I went home last night.
You left them here? By the gift shop?
Yeah, it's no big deal. They were all still here this morning. Kind of.
Kind of?
I think someone played a stupid joke, and my spare black leggings were covered in some disgusting swamp slime when I found them in the bag this morning. If you're going to take my clothes and mess them up, then just keep them. I don't want them back. You know what I mean?
I absolutely do.
Hey, a pair of Sally's black leggings. Schön, dass wir auch ihren Namen wissen. Sally says someone played a joke on her since they are covered in strange liquid slime. Mm-hmm. Sally left these leggings in her bag and left that bag in the swamp last night.
I have a theory that the murderer was wearing a costume. A homemade outfit designed to look like the swamp creature.
I've never seen anything so ridiculous. You've never seen me in that.
I know it's not exactly the latest fashion, but...
No, you'd never see me in that. It would cover me up entirely.
That's the point of a disguise?
Look, detective. When you have legs like mine, you don't want to be wearing disguises.
Is that why you always wear those black leggings?
You've only just met me and you're making assumptions about what I always wear.
And making assumptions is the fun part of being a detective.
Well, you're right. I always wear these.
Darf ich anmerken, dass ihr Ohr richtig merkwürdig platziert ist? Ich könnte denken, dass das eher so eine Öffnung darstellen soll. Da öffnen, um Gesicht abzuziehen.
So what can you tell me about your relationship with Richard Remington?
I didn't have one. I think I spoke to him twice, ever. He usually seemed really busy, but more like preoccupied.
Preoccupied? Like he was thinking about something else? Something that wasn't this tourist attraction?
Who can say? What do old men think about?
What? Are you implying that I know the answer to that?
Okie dokie, Okay, also hier haben wir schon so ein paar Sachen herausgefunden. Bei ihr noch nicht und bei ihr auch noch nicht. Und es fehlt noch eine weitere Person.
Is that one of the other suspects? They're more suspicious than me. Let's agree on that.
Okay, das war also nicht viel. So, du hattest noch irgendwas? One of Sally's belongings. Meine, uns fehlt eigentlich noch eine Sache von dem Kostüm, aber hier ist kein Platz mehr sonst.
They're mine, but I left them here last night. Now they're covered in slime, and I don't want to go near them.
Okay. Dann würde ich sagen, gehen wir auch hier natürlich nochmal hin. Stellen sicher.
The tree comes straight through the middle of the house. It even has little drawers carved into it. Okay, even I'll admit, that's pretty cool.
For a long time. Yep.
Let's see. First thing we do, then tap the.
Yep.
And now.
Yep.
Got it! Now I know what that liquid. I'll write it down in my. The swamp slime. It's the exact same liquid. There's something about that green slime.
My hairstyle. My hairstyle is proof that the swamp creatures belongs to Boggy. Are covered in green powder, are covered in the same swamp dingens. Sally's legs. The fireplace poker. Are the only reason found at the crime scene end? The leggings and the fire pokers are covered in the same slime.
The black leggings, found at the crime scene, and the fireplace poker are covered in the same swamp slime. Oh, That slime keeps showing up in different places.
Have magic powers. Belongs to Boggy. Are covered in green powder. Also found at the crime scene? No. So rum, vermute ich eher.
The fireplace poker, found at the crime scene, and the black leggings are covered in the same swamp slime. Sally's leggings. They link her with the crime scene. I'll have to ask her about it.
Alright, let's do that.
What?
The black leggings you found in your bag this morning, they're covered in the same slime that was on the murder weapon.
Everything in this swamp is covered in slime. What's your angle, Grimoire?
This exact slime hasn't been found anywhere else. Your black leggings were part of the murderer's costume. I prove you were wearing them.
Your black leggings were part of the murderer's costume.
Costume? Is that why someone took them out of my bag last night?
Well, you know, I don't have proof someone else took them.
If I had been wearing them when I committed a crime, do you think I would hand them over to a detective the second he shows up? Besides, look at them. What do you notice?
You're too fat. They're loose and stretched. They're far too long for you to...
They're loose and stretched.
That's right, someone else. Someone larger than me has worn these. They're stretched out, especially at the waist. It's pretty obvious.
So, let's see. Somebody stole them to use in their Boggy costume, and then put them back in your bag when they were done?
If you say so. It's not my job to know all the details. It's my job to sell souvenirs. Do you want a souvenir?
Oh, my, yes. But only if you choose one for me.
You look like you could use something to wind up. You can take this one.
No. A small plastic toy sold at the gift shop. It's a cartoony appearance of Boogie. Boogie's feet are hidden in a bucket of water. Yes, they are. Done talking to her. Okay. Ich guck mal hier. Was uns jetzt hier noch fehlt, weil jetzt sind wir wieder am Anfang.
There's a hollow part of the tree.
Too dark to see inside. Okay.
Is an old statue of Boggy. Is an opportunity for the two characters.
Okay, also das ist hier alles schön und gut. Hast du noch was zu sagen? Denn uns fehlt immer noch eine Person.
Try and solve every suspect's challenge topic. If you're struggling, don't forget to present profiles and clues to people who might be interested. Oh, and hurry up! It's cold in this boat.
Ja, sie hat im Endeffekt nochmal das kurz erklärt, was wir eigentlich eh schon wussten. So, wir hatten das bei ihr hinbekommen.
So.
Bei ihr fehlt uns das noch. Talk to everyone. Present clues and things. Okay, dann werden wir das auch machen, denn ich glaube, nur bei ihr fehlt uns das noch. Present a clue.
If you bring me something with liquid on it, I might be able to help you.
Okay, also das hat sich damit erledigt. Flowerbook, hier fehlt uns noch was. Das Zeug haben wir alles angeguckt.
You can put that away. I can't help you with it.
Ich habe schon so ein bisschen gedacht. Die kennt die doch eh alle nicht.
Show it to someone who doesn't live in a tree.
Ja, uns fehlt...
A fascinating old woman who lives in a wonderful treehouse. I heard she wasn't so keen on visitors, though.
Die anderen dürfte sie doch eigentlich alle nicht kennen.
I'm not even sure who that is.
Ja, hab ich mir schon gedacht.
No, thank you.
Also irgendwas gibt's hier vermutlich noch, aber halt... Das hier können wir maximal noch zeigen.
If you bring me something with...
Okay, also das bringt mir alles nichts. Ja, so, wer fehlt uns jetzt noch? Protest? Oh. Hi.
Ah. You've arrived at a bad time, my friend. For once, they don't actually want tourists walking around this place.
I always arrive at a bad time. It's what I do. I'm a detective, not a tourist.
My apologies. It's just, you have the same wide-eyed expression as the kids that come here. Running around, spending their parents' money, you know.
Well, you know, it's not every day I visit a swamp full of such unique specimens.
It's no problem. You're just thinking what we all thought when we arrived for the first time.
Why didn't they put in a bathroom?
No, you're thinking, this place is beautiful. What a lucky man I am to be here.
I am I? Well, if you say so.
Edward Everstone, at your service.
That's a pretty cool name. Can I call you Ed?
You don't need to. Everyone just calls me Echo.
Why, because it gives you an elevated sense of purpose? Why, because you're a good swimmer? Why, because you'd bounce if I threw you at a wall?
Why? Because it gives you an elevated sense of purpose?
What? No. Because I always come back, again and again, until my job is done.
You're protesting, right?
I certainly am. And now that you're here, I'm getting you involved.
What does that mean? Yeah, I haven't got time to hold up signs for you, I'm sorry.
You simply have to hear my message and take it with you.
Go ahead, I'm all ears. Plus, I have a little notebook.
What was the first thing you felt when you saw the sign for Boggy's Bog looming over you?
Well, I thought it was...
Not thought, felt.
I felt, well, something seemed wrong. There wouldn't be a tourist attraction in the middle of a swamp like this. There shouldn't be.
My job is done. Clearly your brain is working perfectly, Detective.
So you're against the tourist attraction? Yeah, let's see. You'd rather this area was kept as a natural habitat, right?
Right again. And that precise word, habitat. First and foremost, I'm protesting for animal rights.
Well, okay, I'm following you, but it's not like they're cutting down trees or anything like that, right?
All animals deserve the right to live in peace, and I promise you, on a normal day, this place is far from peaceful.
Are you talking about the swamp creature? About Boggy?
A creature like that. He's earned the right to be left alone. We're fools to invite ourselves into his home like this on a daily basis, assuming he's not going to mind. Assuming he'll keep to himself and let us walk around with his face on our t-shirts.
Well, I agree. I think he should be left alone. But like you said, he can probably handle himself. And if no one has even seen him in 60 years, I don't really see the problem.
Unlike you, Detective, I never had an academic calling in life. I was never even a talented artist or musician or anything. So instead, I made the decision to stand up for those who were getting a raw deal.
Yeah.
You come here every day?
Yes, I do.
Well, I'm only going to ask you about one of those days. What were you doing yesterday evening?
I was here at my protest spot until fairly late. Then I went to get something to eat at Harper's Cafe before I...
Wait, you ate at the cafe here? Doesn't supporting the tourist attraction like that kind of go against your protest?
A man has to eat, doesn't he? I don't think the meager contributions of one person are going to keep this place afloat. Especially now.
And you're sleeping here? Doesn't it get cold at night?
Well, I came prepared, of course. I usually find myself with one or two extra layers to wear. Most of this bulk is padding, I promise you.
I'm sure it is. So, you stayed here the whole night?
That's right. And I admit I may have heard some stranger than usual sounds floating around the swamp last night.
What kind of sounds?
It's impossible to say. This place fills with the most terrifying sounds at night. Hundreds of animals, some tiny, some much larger, awaken and make their own protests. Every night until the sun rises in the morning.
Insects make noises at night. Okay, I've written it down.
Yeah.
What can you tell me about these designs for a costume? A Boggy costume.
It's Boggy! I must admit, I've been a fan of his before I ever came to the swamp.
A fan? So you're interested in cryptozoology?
Oh, no, I meant, well, Boggy has been in all kinds of cartoons and comic strips. He's one of the greatest characters of the last 100 years. I've got some comics in my tent. You really should see.
But he was only discovered 60 years ago.
Oh, that's true. Well, I rounded up.
But what about his costume? Have you seen anyone wearing it?
I can honestly say I've never seen anyone wearing anything like that. And I'm a very observant person.
Ja, man kann ja nicht sehen, was jemand tragen könnte, wenn man es selber trägt, nicht wahr?
So, what did Mr. Remington think of you? I mean, protesting in the middle of a swamp every day.
It wasn't his swamp. If he ever truly thought it was, then he was even more of a fool than he seemed.
But he didn't like you hanging around, right?
That man was exceptionally skilled at ignoring me, ignoring anything he didn't like.
So, what, he just left you alone?
He expected me to get bored and go home. He figured I'd get sick of this place and he'd have it back to himself.
But he didn't want it to himself, did he? He wanted lots of people to come visit all the time, surely.
I'm sure it says that in the brochure. Yes.
Haha, wir kriegen ja hier schon so nach und nach mit, dass sie hier vielleicht nicht unbedingt die Touristen mit anlocken wollten. Ah, Curtain Piece. War das Fan auch schon dort? Vielleicht muss ich dann nachher nochmal zu der alten Dame zurück und das nochmal präsentieren.
I'm afraid I have no idea.
Ja, also der Typ ist mir leicht suspekt.
Show it to somebody else.
Okay.
The murder victim.
Since last night, yeah. But he was the owner of Boggy's Bog. Did she know him?
Not personally. To be honest, I'm quite glad about it.
Boggy is my prime suspect, you know. The creature you're trying to protect.
Protect is the wrong word. If your suspicions were correct, we could both agree he's a creature that doesn't need protecting.
You think he might be the murderer?
I think he's a wild animal, and he wants to be left alone at any cost.
Yeah. Die anderen Idioten kennt er bestimmt nicht, aber mindestens Harper muss er kennen.
He seems like a good person. He even sympathizes with my cause.
He agrees with your protest? But he works here, right? And he was friends with Remington.
I think that was the only reason he worked here. Maybe he'll see the light now and leave the swamp behind him. Maybe everyone will.
Oh. I wonder what other things of him. Das wäre ich gar nicht mal dumm zu erfragen, ja. Geh trotzdem mal hier hin als erstes. Present a clue.
If you bring me something.
Okay, also das ist ja alles.
You should ask someone.
Okay, hätte vielleicht gedacht, dass das so die einzige Person sein könnte, die ernsthaft ihm auf den Keks gegangen ist. Gut, dann gehen wir vom Gift Shop los. Und präsentieren mal so ein paar Sachen. Obwohl, eine Sache könnten wir auch noch vorher machen.
I have no idea what that is.
Okay, also das wurde da reingeschmuggelt.
That is not something from my gift shop. I've never seen it before.
Interessant. Interessant.
Where are you keeping all this stuff? In your pockets? Is that one of your clues? It's nice. You can put it away now.
Okay, also die hilft uns in der Hinsicht nicht weiter.
I can draw way better than that.
Can you show me?
There's no time. Maybe in the sequel. I have no idea what that is.
It's a photo.
Yeah, I have a pretty good view of him from here. Anyone supporting animal rights is okay in my book. His protest used to have a bit more energy, though. He spends more time inside his tent these days.
What's he doing in there?
I'm happy to say, I don't know.
There might be something I can ask Echo about.
Okay. My labels. Echo has recently acquired my breakfast and plans to eat it. What? Okay. Because he's so terrified. What? Has never spoken to, spends more time holding. Ja, aber gerade das war ja der Gegenteil. Also hier, Echo spends more time holding the protest sign and less time in his tent. Ist ja eigentlich nicht der Fall. Ich probier's trotzdem mal ganz kurz.
Echo spends more time holding the protest sign and more time in his tent.
Echo spends less time holding. Ja, das macht jetzt mehr Sinn.
Echo spends less time holding the protest sign and more time in his tent. I wonder if Echo can tell me what he's been doing that's more important than his protest.
Done talking, shit. Dann gehen wir natürlich dorthin wieder zurück.
I heard you've been spending less time protesting recently and more time, in your tent. Normally I wouldn't pry, but it's my job to ask.
Untouched people have even noticed something like that. I usually get the impression everyone else is doing their best to ignore me.
So, you admit it's true?
You can put your notebook away. There isn't really any reason for it. Nothing worth writing down, at least.
Well, if it's not worth writing down, maybe it's worth hearing.
In that case, you'd forget it.
How do you know? Maybe it would echo in my mind.
Look, if you take a guess and get it right, I promise not to deny it.
Let's work out why Echo was hidden away in his tent. Notebook time.
I have a silly nickname. Hidden away in his tent wegen Regen, wegen Geistern, wegen Dings oder wegen... Maybe?
You've been in your tent, hiding from Boggy!
Why not?
Challenge complete? Ernsthaft?
I heard you've been spending less time in your tent. Normally I wouldn't pry, but it's my job to ask...
Untouched people have even noticed something like that.
So, you would... Let's work out notebook time.
Probieren wir mal Regen.
You've been in your tent because it's been raining!
Why not?
Huh. Achievement dafür bekommen? Was interessanterweise aber ein Schleim dargestellt hat. Okay. So.
I'm impressed someone managed to pitch a tent here. And I'm impressed someone would want to. It's a colorful, boggy-themed padlock. He's staring into my soul. It should open if I set the right number.
Oh, boy. Okay, Nummer. Haben wir irgendeine Nummer angetroffen bisher? Ich hab keine Ahnung. Lass mal... Sechs von sieben. Von wem haben wir denn das noch nicht? Von ihr fehlt uns das weiterhin, okay. Clues. 2045 wäre lustig. Lass uns das als erstes probieren. Yes. You can click and hold the back button.
I'm impressed someone might- It's a piece.
Yes. Wir probieren mal den ersten offensichtlichen.
It's Echo's tent. It's a keys.
Ich gehe davon aus, das Ding geht auf von alleine.
It's Echo's tent.
Ja, also das ist nicht. Gucken wir weiter. Ja, viel fehlt es nicht mehr. Ich finde es halt interessant, dass halt von diesem Kostüm eigentlich nur das Mittelteil noch fehlt. Und das ist bisher irgendwie uninteressant gewesen. Die Map. Gibt es hier irgendwelche Ansagen? No. Das fände ich überraschend, wenn uns das irgendwas gesagt hätte. Film-Footage. Da könnte man sagen, das ist eine dieser Nummern, aber das ist, glaube ich, ein bisschen zu weit hergezogen. 60 Years, wie gesagt, das ist das Einzige, was wir so haben als Nummer. Und da fehlen dann noch ein paar Ziffern. Ja, ich gehe jetzt gerade so einzeln eher durch. Weil es halt so ein bisschen andere Sprünge macht, als ich will. Hier sind sie überhaupt keine Nummern am Start. Folder-Files. Ich meine, ja, es hat vermutlich irgendwas mit dem Vieh zu tun, aber bis auf 60 Jahre her haben wir nicht allzu viel. Und vor allem immer noch so ein paar Sachen, die wir überhaupt nicht wissen. Oh, 1963. Ist das vielleicht einer von den Typen? Einer mit einem sehr roten Bart. Der vielleicht? Oder der? 1963.
I'm impressed, Anna. It's Echo's.
Ich weiß nicht, wie man das Ding dann aufmacht.
It's a keys.
Doch, ist eigentlich richtig, ne? Oder es wird das Ganze vielleicht genau andersrum. Das kann ja auch sein, dass es einfach anders das Ganze zählt.
It's Echo's. It's a keys.
Ja, keine Ahnung. Keine Ahnung.
These flower petals seem a little out of place, lying on the ground over there. These flower...
Okay... Hat uns das irgendwas geholfen in der Hinsicht? Oh, interessant. Ich meine, wir haben hier die blue and red petals, genau. Hier fehlt uns beim Museum insgesamt selbst noch eine Sache. Bei The Woods. Ja genau, das mit dem Bodending, das müssen wir uns nochmal angucken, genau. Ah, einfach so länger gedrückt hat. Okay. Gehen wir mal hier hin, gucken nochmal. Nope, das ist nicht richtig. Woods. Oh, hi.
Aha, the great detective returns. Did you run out of ideas? Need a little push in the right direction?
I'm getting a new idea. It involves ignoring you. No need to push me, but the direction would help. You're the one who needs a little push.
No need to push me, but the direction would help.
Like it or not, I'm here to help you.
I get it. You give me a map, then you magically disappear and hide behind a tree for an hour. You want me to be impressed?
Did you talk to all the suspects yet?
I'm working on it. You can't rush these things, you know.
Have you noticed anything unusual?
I notice that this is going to take longer than I originally planned, and I'm getting the feeling that I wasn't wrong about this tourist attraction.
What do you mean?
I had a hard time believing there could be a place like this here in a dark corner of a swamp. It didn't make sense, and it still doesn't.
Some things don't make sense straight away. You need to look a little closer.
At what? The mud? The water? The trees?
Nope. They've been here for years, and they're not to blame. They belong here.
She's gone again. Hiding in a bush, no doubt. I wonder if she'll ever tell me something I can actually understand. What's this? Looks like that maybe if...
Okay, also das Zeug wurde wieder anders bewegt. Gucken wir nochmal, ob hier irgendwas ist. Ich dachte vielleicht, dass irgendwie das, was am Boden hier ist, was man gerade eben nicht bewegen kann, bis noch irgendwas zu sagen hat. Und das da irgendwie mit halt anbringen soll oder ähnliches, aber... Genau. Bis hier ist es alles eher nicht wirklich hilfreich gewesen. Verstehst du, wenn man sagt, man würde das hier noch mitnehmen? Aber dieses Blatt macht so nicht wirklich mit. Also, das ist das einzige Puzzle bisher, was ich noch nicht verstanden habe. Ich dachte gerade so, dass mit dem, dass die Steine wirklich, vielleicht muss ich auch um die Steine gucken. Aber zum Beispiel die weiß ich nicht, was die sollen. Vielleicht muss ich versuchen, einfach alles eher darauf zu beziehen. Man wirklich sagt, man versucht das eher so übereinander tatsächlich zu lappen. Aber selbst dann, was ist das denn hier jetzt? Ha. Also das finde ich immer noch halt das Logischste von allen. Ich weiß nicht, was man mit dem anderen Zeug macht. Hier ist halt immer noch so ein Stück frei. Also ich denke, ich werde mich mal ganz kurz hier hinsetzen. Noch ein bisschen weiter probieren. Also, ich weiß nicht, was... Also diese vier Dinger sind mir so unklar. Und ich weiß halt nicht, ob hier irgendwas ist, was ich im Hintergrund noch nutzen soll. Ob man sagt, hey, man muss diese Baumstammsachen nutzen. Aber die sehen halt so random aus. Nachdem ich mir jetzt hier für ein paar Minuten das Ganze ein bisschen herumbewegt hatte und mir auch noch diese Stellen hier angeguckt habe, bekomme ich das Gefühl, dass die tatsächlich was zu sagen haben. Dass hier gar nicht der Witz ist, dass man eine Spur versucht zu erstellen, sondern mehrere. Genau. Das ist tatsächlich der Fall.
I recognize that footprint.
Damn, ich hatte wirklich gedacht, dass es konstant halt ein Fußabdruck ist, aber klar, es sind zwei.
It's the same as the one found at the crime scene.
Aha. Hat uns das jetzt irgendwas gebracht? The Three Towers, ja, okay. Museum fehlt uns einer. Geht jetzt mal wirklich einfach alle ab. Da fehlt uns einfach Protest. Crossroad. No clues, okay. Und Office, da fehlt uns ebenfalls noch einer. Und Treehouse. Und aber auch Gift Shop. Und Café fehlen uns gleich noch zwei. Holy shit. Okay, dann würde ich sagen, wir gehen als allererstes zum Museum. Was ist hier, was uns noch fehlt?
This is a really cramped museum. Just one room? Not worth the admission price. Things in jars. Who? I don't like things in jars. Unless the thing is marmalade. These are skulls? Oh, they're just models. Creepy models. Books about Boggy and other mysterious creatures. I'll read them some other time. This is a really not...
Wir wussten, hier fehlt eine Seite, ne?
Some educational fact. Did you know?
Ich weiß noch nichts.
Hmm. In a different. It's only recent. That might explain why. It's a poster from the old Boggy cartoon.
Oh, interessant.
Boggy playing the piano. He's having a grand old time. It says another story from Boggy's bog. But actually, I think this is from the very first episode.
Swamp Studios, providing the best in swamp-based animated entertainment. It's a poster from Copyright MCMXXXIV. That'll be 1934?
Okay, dann gehen wir natürlich auch jetzt hier gleich und probieren diese Sache wiederum aus.
I'm impressed someone and I...
Ja. Warum immer das jetzt hier geändert worden ist. Probieren wir erstmal wieder die Logik. 1934.
It's Echo's 10. It's a piece.
Okay, dann probieren wir das andersrum. Man weiß ja nie, wie das Spiel das haben möchte.
It's a journal. I guess it belongs to Echo. Bad news. Remington is dead. I don't know what to do. Was my whole protest in vain? They'll shut this place down, sure, but I'll never know if I got through to him. That's all he's written.
Present a clue? Ist leider keiner.
Show it to somebody else.
Die anderen sind dir doch vermutlich scheißegal.
Ah yes, Agent Folder. A good man.
You know him?
We get on rather well. And we shared a number of views on the way things were run around here.
Feel like I'm done talking to him. Okay, dann... Crossroads sollten wir nochmal gucken. How?
You again. Ready with some cryptic advice, no doubt?
Don't let them take him.
Who? The murderer? That's my job. I gotta make sure that
no,
they...
No! The creature! Don't take him away. This place is his home.
Oh, Boggy. Hey, don't worry. I didn't really believe he could be, responsible for this mess.
You didn't?
Well, no.
Mainly because I don't believe he exists at all. I don't believe he could ever hurt anyone. I've always known who the murderer was, and it's not Boggy.
I've always known who the murderer was, and it's not Boggy.
So, he won't get in trouble? He won't have to leave?
Well, he's been out here for, what, 60 years, hasn't he? And stayed out of trouble for that long. I have a feeling some detective isn't going to change all that in one day.
Well, in that case... He says, thank you.
Okay.
Note to self, don't fall in.
Was soll denn hier los sein?
It's a fork in the road. How non-linear. It's the base of a gigantic tree, and it's sitting in the very heart of the swamp. Was this entire place built around it?
That's a clue. Ich sehe mir nicht, dass das ein Clou sein soll. Okay, gucken wir aber trotzdem nochmal hier durch. Next. Das haben wir. Museum haben wir. Café fehlen uns zwei. Giftshop fehlt uns einer. Treehouse fehlt uns einer. Office fehlt uns einer. Okay, dann würde ich sagen, nächste ist Office. So geht das hier nicht. Was fehlt uns hier? Uns das angeguckt.
This is the creepiest. The open window looks over the wooden planks outside. Oh, and on one side a part of the curtain has been ripped off. Hunting memorabilia. Claws, teeth. It would be an impressive collection if it wasn't so disturbing.
Ja, okay, das hätte ich aber auch darauf abgeleitet, wenn ich alles andere hier gesehen hätte. Das hilft mir so überhaupt nicht weiter. Das Museum hatten wir, Office hatten wir, Outside hatten wir, Clearing hatten wir, Protest hatten wir, Pass, Woods, Bridge, Treehouse fehlt uns noch was. Okay.
Check out that sunlight beaming through the window. It's so bright I should have brought my sunglasses. I'm indoors. What a treat.
The owner of this house seems to... Though... I'm indoors. I'm indoors. The tree comes straight through the... It even has... Okay, even... Check out that sunlight.
Okay, hier soll noch irgendwas sein, aber ich weiß halt leider nicht was. Ja, ich habe keine Ahnung, was hier noch fehlen könnte.
There's a book on the table. I think it's a book about flowers. How fascinating. I must take some time to read it.
Das war ein Clou, Dinges. Kaffee fehlen uns zwei, Giftshop fehlen uns noch einer, genau. Ich weiß wirklich nicht, warum halt das jetzt noch wichtig war, aber gut.
Water, water everywhere, and not a drop to drink. Seriously, I'm not drinking that. The tables and chairs are made out of parts of a ship, I think. Never really learned much about ships. There's a little locked door on the side of the ship here. I think it's part of the cafe. A shipwreck? And why is there a cafe growing out of the side?
Okay, damit haben wir auch das wiederum. Also ich habe das Gefühl, dass uns das nicht allzu viel weiterhilft, weil die meisten Punkte wir schon so ein bisschen annehmen.
There aren't many clues over here. Unless those trees are a clue. But I don't think so. There aren't many clues over here, but I don't think... It's a humble gift shop wagon.
Okay, das hatten wir aber.
I'm not going to worry about how frail that wooden path looks. Nope.
Okay, aber also wie sonst ist hier nicht. Guck mal, was für Clues wir hier allgemein schon hatten. Der Boogie Toys und Bored Looking Lady. Ja, okay.
It's a humble...
Was könnte hier noch sein?
Brightly colored boggy baseball caps.
Tatsächlich, das ist es.
Is there something behind them? What on earth? It's some kind... There's a strange... Two clues for the price of... A boggy's bog... Maybe I'll get... Brightly... Is there something behind them?
Achso, das ist damit gemeint. Okay, A child's head sold at the gift shop designed to look a little like boggy. Okay. Ja, damit haben wir 100% davon. Oh, man kann auch einfach so draufklicken, natürlich angenehmer. Es scheint wirklich nur noch diese eine Sache hier zu fehlen. Und dann haben wir die Suspects, wo auch nur von der alten Dame die Sache fehlt. Ich würde sagen, wir gehen nochmal zurück zum Museum und versuchen mit dem Typen zu reden.
So.
Einfach, oh.
I found these designs for a boggy costume.
Oh, some ridiculous new merchandise for tourists to waste their money on.
No, I believe the murderer was dressed like this last night when they attacked Remington.
If they were trying to scare him out of the swamp, they should have spent more time making an accurate design.
What do you mean?
Well, this design is some bizarre hybrid between the real creature and the cartoon character. It simply hasn't been researched properly.
What's wrong with it?
Well, those flippers? Pure guesswork. Nothing but foolish imagination. Nobody knows what Boggy's feet look like. No footprint has ever been recorded.
So tell me, Special Agent Folder, how would you do a better job researching it if nothing has ever been recorded?
Oh, well, that's, you know, I mean, it's all a matter of taking the time to... It's just that... But there's no way anyone would believe... Nothing but foolishness.
What can you tell me about your relationship with Richard Remington?
We didn't really have one, and now we definitely don't have one. But look, all I can say is that he was a coward who enjoyed watering down history for his own benefit.
What does that mean?
It means there are some chapters of this swamp's history that he never wanted anyone to know about.
Did he like you sniffing around this museum all the time?
I don't think he knew, to be honest. And even if he did, there's nothing he could have done about it. He has no right to this building. He knows that. We both know that.
Why not? It was part of his tourist attraction, wasn't it?
No. It wasn't.
Wow.
An important piece of the puzzle! This journal is a key to unlocking the history of this place.
Das hilft mir nicht weiter.
Actually, this is a classic example of a cryptid photograph.
What's a cryptid?
A creature unknown to science. Look at the slight blurring in this photo, the murky exposure. It's perfect.
It's perfect because it can't really be used as evidence?
Now you're catching on. A good example of how Boggy's feet are never shown in any form, they often use that little red bucket to hide them. This is just a piece of junk they sell to tourists. It has no resemblance to the real creature. I have no interest in something like that. Obviously.
Obviously.
You're wasting your precious time, Detective.
If you say so.
I've never seen that before, and I never want to see it again. So, you found it. I wonder who else knows about it. I have no interest in something like that. Obviously.
Obviously.
The real swamp creature had claws. 3 on each hand, to be precise. Why does the costume just have these pathetic fins instead? Guesswork. Nobody can know what Boggy's feet look like. It's his greatest secret. You're wasting your precious time, Detective. Well, this design is some bizarre hybrid between the real creature.
Okay, das hatten wir.
Oh, yes, I know him. He occasionally asks me about the history and biology of the swamp creature. I explain to him what the real Boggy looks like and how they changed his appearance for the cartoon character.
Why did he ask about that?
Because some people are naturally curious. You should give it a try sometime.
Thanks. Okay, was fehlt uns jetzt noch? Uns fehlt diese eine Sache. Und diese eine Sache. Ich würde sagen, wir gehen zu ihr. Und gehen ihr so lange auf die Nerven, bis sie uns irgendwie weiterhilft.
This is a 60-year-old journal. It was on display in a museum.
I know what it is.
I thought you might. I'm supposed to look to the past, right?
Lady Weybridge killed the swamp creature when a boogie head was discovered by the explorer 20 years ago. Richard Remington founded Boogie's Bog when... Boogie became a famous cartoon character. Was hunted and killed. Was living in the swamp when? ...20 years ago.
Lady Weybridge was living in the swamp when the swamp creature was discovered by the explorer 60 years ago. Lady Weybridge. She was living here when Boggy was first discovered by the explorer. I've been looking into the history of this place.
Oh, really? Did you find anything?
Yeah. You.
You must be confused. You found me today, when you barged into my house. Remember?
You were living in the swamp when the explorer visited 60 years ago. You created the myth of the swamp creature yourself to scare people away. You were the original founder of the tourist attraction.
You were already living in the swamp when the explorer came here 60 years ago.
The explorer? That man they talk about in the museum?
The one who originally discovered Boggy. You know who I'm talking about. His sketches and notes are the only real evidence we have for this creature.
You already have his journal. You learned to read, I assume. What else do you need?
I need you to tell me if the journal is fake. There's a page missing from the journal. I think you know where it is. I think you wrote something in the journal yourself, no?
There's a page missing from the journal. I think you know where it is.
Why on earth would I know something like that?
Because you were the only person here when the explorer visited the swamp. I have a suspicion that the swamp creature wasn't the only thing he discovered.
You're suggesting he gave me a page from the back of his journal? Or what, that I stole it?
You stole it from him before he left the swamp. I really have no idea. If I could see it, I might be able to make up my mind. You took it from the journal while it was on display in the museum.
You took it from the journal while it was on display in the museum. And let's think about this one again.
Okay, das hat es jetzt komplett abgebrochen, anstatt einfach nur den Schritt zurückzugehen.
Yeah.
So you stole it from before you left the swamp.
You stole it from it.
Okay, auch nicht.
Oh, really? Yeah.
Okay, dann haben wir eigentlich nur noch eins.
You were that.
You all. You learned.
There's a pay. I.
You're. Or.
I really haven't. Okay.
I really have no idea. If I could see it, I might be able to make up my mind.
It doesn't belong in a museum. It belongs here, with me. You understand?
What if I promise I'll return it after I finish clearing up this mess?
Then I'll show it to you.
Is this you? He drew you into his journal? It's beautiful.
60 years ago, yes. He left the page with me. We agreed the rest of the world would manage without it.
I think there's something on the back. What's this? Footprints.
Whose footprints are these? The lost page ripped out of the Explorer's journal given to Weybridge by the Explorer 6 years ago features a drawing of Lady Weybridge at 20 years old. Mm-hmm. Also features drawings of Boogie's feet and footprint. He has 2 feet at the front and 1 at the back. This page proves the footprints found outside the office were not made by the real Boogie. Okay, 92% haben wir angeblich hier nur. Wenn ich dann wieder die Frage habe, was fehlt uns jetzt hier noch? Wir müssen jetzt einfach nur hingehen und realisieren, wer es ist. Denn ich würde ihm das ganz gerne mal so nochmal zeigen.
Is that the missing page of the journal?
I think so.
It's an important artifact. It belongs in a museum.
Yeah, you're not wearing the right hat to be saying that.
Okay, das hat mir alles nicht zu helfen. Ja, okay, 98%, 90% haben wir hier. Ich kann euch nicht sagen, was uns jetzt noch fehlt. Meine, die, wie man sieht, das ist hier wirklich dazugehörig. Achso, wir könnten maximal gucken, was für Sachen wir noch nicht herausgefunden haben. Der hat noch jeweils 2 Sachen. Harper hat noch eine Sache. Der hat noch eine Sache. Da fehlen noch 2. Der ist fertig. Der ist fertig. Er hat noch 2 Sachen.
Hey.
Und sie ist durch, okay. Okay, dann sollten wir jetzt gucken bei ihm als erstes.
Ah.
Mit was sie ihm jetzt noch nerven können.
What?
You're not a bad detective.
Well, I found the photo in Remington's office. It was ripped up, though. I think he was some kind
of... He was a lot of things. Don't lose that picture. And show it to Mr. Harper before you leave.
Na, das ist doch mein Anfang. Das ist doch mein Anfang.
One of Mr. Remington's secrets. I never wanted to know the details, but
These men travel the world, seeking mysterious animals to hunt. They consider myths and legends to be the ultimate prey.
Ja, das erklärt auch die Sammlung in seinem verdammten Office. Dann fehlt es like I'm done talking to him. Uns fehlt uns immer noch eine Sache. Stays up late but locks up when he leaves. Also er ist natürlich schon leicht fragwürdig. Aber natürlich auch ein einfaches Opfer zum Teil.
You have a lot of suspects on that list. He was a friend for many years. If you have any questions about him or his belongings, I may be able to help you.
Okay.
He eats here a lot. I think he's been putting less effort into his protests recently. Which is a shame. I think it's an admirable cause.
Do you talk to him much?
Not really. Sometimes he likes to talk, just casual conversation. He asks how business is going and what everyone likes to eat. Nothing of real importance.
Uh-huh. Interessanterweise, wir haben 1995, aber hier haben wir 100% erreicht.
A man who has sacrificed luxuries to protect those who need protecting. Pretty good beard, too.
Ich meine, das hat mir jetzt nicht wirklich geholfen.
Show it to somebody else.
Na, ich weiß jetzt wirklich nicht, was ich jetzt hier noch großartig machen muss. Ich meine, ihm fehlt noch irgendwas. Irgendwas ist hier, was wir noch entdecken müssen.
Oh? No thanks, my friend. I'm afraid I have no idea.
Uh-huh. Do you know?
This is the journal, correct? The one that man left here 60 years ago?
You seem a little unsure of the details. Shouldn't you have read up on all this stuff?
Forgive me. It's hard for me to get the image of Boggy as the lovable cartoon character out of my mind. He's just so iconic. Did you know, in 1973, he...
But you're protesting to protect the real swamp creature. The cartoon character is just some commercial byproduct, right?
Yes, yes, of course.
Ja, ja, Echo, du wirkst immer, immer fragwürdiger, mein lieber Freund. So, damit haben wir aber auch hier wiederum alles. Er hat noch welche und dann fehlt uns noch der Kollege am Ende. Greetings.
I found these designs for a costume, a Boggy costume.
Aha, the legendary swamp creature.
Yeah, that's the one.
But these are just a child's drawings, are they not?
You think?
Perhaps. It's difficult to tell.
You saw Remington last night, but had you met him before? Did you know him?
I've never really spoken with him, but we've come into contact a few times. Vincent likes to handle that kind of work, and I like to let him.
What do you think of this place? The tourist attraction, I mean.
I can't say I like the idea of a natural area like this becoming commercialized.
I know! I just can't understand why anyone would even try!
I think Mr. Remington had his reasons. He looked like a man with a couple of secrets.
Like what?
I have no idea. If I knew, they wouldn't be secrets.
Okay. Dann sagen wir mal das hier.
That's great.
Doesn't give a fuck. Haben wir damit? Damit haben wir alles schon wieder.
What can you tell me about these designs for a Boggy costume?
Nothing whatsoever.
You're sure you didn't see anything like this while you were filming yesterday? Wait, hold on a minute. What if
don't
you...
Don't you dare ask.
This costume isn't your doing, is it? Made for your movie, I mean?
My friend, there will be no costumed idiots within the viewfinder of my camera. I can assure you that.
What about your Boggy movie? Isn't that going to be, like, a guy in a costume or a puppet or one of those weird robot things?
Technology has been kind to people like me. We no longer have any need for such tomfoolery. I can create a perfectly believable swamp creature within the confines of a computer. Much cheaper, too.
Huh. I suppose you've met with our murder victim, Richard Remington.
Yes, I've been in and out of this place for a while now. Naturally, I've crossed paths with Remington a number of times. Good value, that one. A real raconteur, you know.
You liked him? So far, I'm getting the impression he wasn't the most popular guy around here.
Well, that much is clear, isn't it? The man obviously slipped up somewhere, made an enemy or two, and bam, that's that. You just can't be too careful, can you?
Yeah, I think he did have an enemy or two. Or three. But you liked him.
I respected him. Good head on his shoulders. Good business sense, that man. He understood how to make things work for him.
Okay.
I don't really have time to be looking at items from your collection.
He doesn't give a fuck.
I think it's time I went to talk to Officer James.
No. The beginning of the end, aber wir haben noch hier einen Clou, der uns fehlt. You know? Und das würde ich mir natürlich auch ganz gerne nochmal angucken.
So. There's an open window above Rem. One of the curtains.
Ha, ich hätte mir vielleicht erhofft, dass man irgendwie. Was fehlt uns noch? Wir haben 92%. Ich meine, ja, jetzt fehlen uns hier scheinbar noch so einzelne Punkte an und für sich. Ja, also ich habe so das Gefühl, dass man jetzt so anfangen müsste. Wir haben nie das Bodypiece gefunden, aber genau, sieht halt so ein bisschen aus wie ein Poncho. Jetzt müsste man vermutlich noch gucken, ob man irgendwie Kaffee vielleicht nochmal guckt, ob der irgendwas von der Rifle mir erzählen kann.
That's Mr. Remington's old hunting rifle. He usually keeps it around. For whatever reason. He was very fond of that thing. Looks like it was fired recently.
Ha. Das wiederum ist interessant. Das ist interessant.
Grass, tree.
Ja, ja, ja. Clues. Ein bisschen schade, dass man hier nicht vielleicht von Anfang an sehen kann. Der Hut. Das Pulverzeug. Okay, dann versuche ich nochmal mit ihm hier weiterzureden.
It was Mr. Remington's favorite food. That strange green powder isn't supposed to be there.
Okay, da kann man nicht helfen.
I can't help you with that one. Sorry.
Dann versuchen wir mal mit ihr nochmal zu reden.
These hats look pretty stupid. Luckily, kids seem to like stupid stuff.
You sell a lot of them?
Yeah, they're pretty popular.
Ja, also ich habe wirklich das Gefühl, dass halt Echo das Ganze ist.
Where are you keeping all this stuff? In your pockets?
Okay, jetzt fehlt noch die Hotdog-Sache. Wer könnte uns diesbezüglich helfen? Ich meine, hier sind nicht allzu viele Leute, aber trotzdem. Kann dem das versuchen, nochmal anzudrehen? Bin mir nicht so sicher, ob ich das schon mal gemacht hatte. Okay. Harper hatten wir. Wir können maximal. Oh ja, wir können auch dem Kameramann den Hotdog mal andrehen. Ich weiß, der noch was.
That's the food I saw Mr. Remington eating at the cafe last night.
before he got ill and rushed back to his office?
That's right.
This is going down to my notebook. It might be important.
Okay, damit fehlt jetzt noch die eine weitere... Nope, das ist es sogar. Das Bild. Mal gucken, ob ich den dazu bezüglich schon angesprochen hatte.
Yes, that's my photograph, taken near the woods at the north end of Boggy's Bog. Have you tried looking there?
He's a talented man, that Burl. Sometimes I wonder if he'd be better off pursuing his photography full-time, you know?
Nope, da wollte ich jetzt nicht hin.
What's this?
Okay, that's up in here.
The water's clear, I can see my... Not bad. It's like a little f... It's like a little f...
Ich hätte gehofft, dass man vielleicht hier nochmal irgendwas sehen würde bezüglich des Fotos, aber das ist scheinbar egal. Was habe ich hier gezeigt gehabt? Okay, das hilft mir alles gerade nicht weiter.
Hey. This was taken near the forest at the back of the swamp, correct?
Yes, I think so.
Mm-hmm. The water is really clear back there. The legs of this thing are reflected in the bottom half of the photo. It's a nice shot, actually.
A reflection? Oh, yeah, of course. A reflection in the water.
Ja, also im Endeffekt ist, denke ich, relativ klar. Das wurde da genommen, da haben wir die Fußspuren im Boden gefunden gehabt. Also ich bin immer noch ganz klar davon überzeugt, dass halt fell through the window after being stabbed. No step by the...
Not suspicious. Suspicious?
Also ich verstehe nicht, warum man halt suspicious und not suspicious sagt. Ich hätte eher gesagt true or not true. Deswegen, das würde ich sagen.
Not suspicious. Not suspicious.
Das stimmt. Remington belongs to a group of hunters who seeks out.
Not suspicious.
Was secretly trying to hunt and kill. Yeah.
Not suspicious.
His body was found outside his office in the swamp.
Not suspicious.
Was fired at least once.
Not suspicious.
Received three small wounds on his chest.
Not suspicious.
Has mysterious slander on his wounds. Yep.
Not suspicious.
Also, das stimmt also erstmal in der Hinsicht. Okay, gehen wir sonst hier durch. Sally only began walking in the swamp.
Not suspicious.
Thinks the swamp is disgusting.
Not suspicious.
Has long legs.
Not suspicious. Not suspicious. Not suspicious.
Kann man eigentlich sagen als, hey...
Not suspicious? Not suspicious.
Das hier ist maximal. Aber dadurch, dass er ja scheinbar eh konstant drin war.
Not suspicious.
Hm. Shares many views with Agent Fodor. Keine Ahnung, kann man nicht wirklich sagen.
Not suspicious.
Protest has been ignored by Remington so far.
Not suspicious.
Not talented artist. Das ist suspicious, definitiv. Is protesting for animal rights, has been spreading, has spending more time in his tent recently, yes. Das ist suspicious, das ist suspicious, ja. Aber gerade in der Verbindung, dass wir gelernt hatten. Das ist theoretisch alles super suspicious. Definitiv das hier. Das ist es eigentlich auch in der Hinsicht. Disgust. Das ist super suspicious. Meine, ja, so sieht es halt doof aus, aber das sind eher so Fakten, die interessant sind, aber nicht auf Harper bezogen. Also bin ich mal gespannt, wie das dann ablaufen wird, denn ich bleibe immer noch dabei, dass Echo derjenige ist. Ausnahme halt mit der, wie heißt's, der Tatsache mit diesem einen Bucheintrag. Da will ich auch nochmal ganz kurz gucken, was da nochmal dahinter steckt.
I'm impressed someone, and I... It's a journal. Like bad news. Remington is dead.
Was wiederum eine interessante Aussage ist.
I don't know what to do. Was my whole protest in vain? They'll shut this place down, sure, but I'll never know if I got through to him.
Ja, und die letzte Sache, keine Ahnung.
Hmm, that's all he's written.
Okay, gehen wir zurück. Muss ehrlich zugeben, dass ich noch nicht so hundertprozentig sicher bin. Ich würde zwar immer noch sagen, er, weil er scheinbar halt Zeit in seinem Zelt verbracht hat, wo er vielleicht das Ganze gemacht hat, ganz klar nicht wirklich wusste, auf was er sich konzentrieren muss, der Poncho halt am Start war, der als Basis dient, den wir sonst alles nicht finden konnten. Also...
Ah, you finally returned! Well, did you find the swamp creature? Where is he?
I didn't find him.
I didn't find him.
What? You're not getting paid to wander about aimlessly, Grimoire! Get back out there!
I don't need to.
So, final chapter, Boggy's criminal record.
Why not? I thought he was our prime suspect.
Not anymore.
Didn't you find photographic evidence of Boggy from last night? Let me see that photo. If that's not Boggy, what is it?
I found designs for the costume in a trash can. Not only that, I collected all the pieces of the costume myself. Well, nearly all of them. There's still the one that...
But the footprints at the scene of the crime! How can you prove these don't belong to a real creature? What's this? I thought there were no records of a footprint anywhere!
No public records. The footprints at the crime scene don't match the ones on this page. They were just a product of these slippers. A part of the costume.
But Grimoire, this costume, it doesn't have claws of any kind. How do you explain the three wounds on the victim's chest?
The prongs match up with the wounds perfectly. The handle is even covered in slime, see?
Ah, but this swamp slime was one of the reasons Boggy became a suspect in the first place. Surely this only incriminates the creature further.
You'd think so, wouldn't you? But that slime, it's not exactly what you think. This stuff has an uncanny resemblance to the so-called swamp slime. A bunch of it was stolen from the storeroom of the cafe, which reminds me.
What is that, exactly?
A poisoned hot dog. It's the second reason that the murderer broke into the storeroom. He put this green powder on the entire supply, just to make sure.
To make sure of what?
Return to make sure no one would eat it ever again. To make sure everyone in the swamp would be... No.
To make sure Remington got ill and had to return to his office.
Remington went back to his office? Alone?
In the dark. Final chapter. Das dritte? The murderer.
I've been looking through your evidence, Grimoire. One piece in particular seems critical to me. I think we need to work
the
out...
Video footage? Vincent Vanderpeer filmed it last night, at the exact moment of the murder, I believe.
Well, exactly. I think we can both agree these sounds in the background. They're essential in our mystery. Could you talk me through them? Just rearrange the descriptions on the left to match the sounds on the right. Drag them around and keep swapping until you're happy with the order. And if you want to hear the sounds again, you can tap on them.
No problem. I can always check my case file if I want to go over my notes.
Your interception to match songs, genau. Drag the white box to swap positions, tap on sound. Das klingt wie eine Tür. Cries out in shock and falls backwards. Das könnte ein Schuss sein. Das könnte das Stechen sein. Ah, hier, das ist anders, ja. Dann muss das und das dahin kommen. Na, sie Dings kommen, sie schießt. Wird die Griffen und die Stochen. Lands on the planks outside his office. Das stimmt natürlich auch nicht. Falls backwards. Gott, damit wie das ja alles. So. Cries out in shock and falls backwards. Okay, definitiv. Culprit drops the metal things. Jetzt muss ich erstmal ein bisschen gucken, wie das hier. Das müsste es ja sein. Das Thud-Geräusch ist das da.
Excellent. There's just two small details bothering me. First of all, if Remington ripped off a piece of his curtains, why wasn't it found at the crime scene? What happened to it?
Turns out the murderer took that piece of fabric and concealed it inside the head of the costume. Then he fled the crime scene to hide all the parts in different areas of the swamp.
Ah, well, that's my problem. If Remington fired his rifle, how did the assailant survive and manage to escape? Did Remington miss his target?
At point blank, a man of his experience? I don't think so. In fact, the answer to that question is the very last link in our chain, the one thing that has eluded me so far. I'll drag the clue items from the left onto my drawing here, and we'll see what happens when we compare the pieces I collected with the original design I found.
Wait! You never found the body piece! The torso!
You're right. And I never would have found it. Not lying around. Not like the others.
But what does this have to do with the murderer surviving the rifle shot?
This torso is probably made up of some thick material. Something covering the culprit's entire upper body. I believe it may have even been enough to soften
the impact from a bullet! Aha!
Exactly.
Well, let's put your theory to the test. Where is that last piece of the costume?
Oh, vielleicht in the crossroads?
Where is that last piece of the costume?
Der hatte wirklich vielleicht in diesem Baum drin.
But how?
Okay,
we looked everywhere. Not a single clue.
Simple. He's still wearing it.
Ja, okay, damit ist es klar.
I don't know what you want with me. Sounds like you two were smart enough to uncover the real criminal in this swamp, and lucky enough to have somebody else deal with him for you. You worked it out. He had his rifle on him. He got half a glance at me and pulled the trigger without hesitation.
But why would he do that? You were dressed as Buggy. He shouldn't be pointing his gun at a unique scientific specimen, not to mention his main attraction.
You're right. It doesn't make sense.
It doesn't make sense, does it? Not unless you're in on the secret.
The hunting photo leads me to believe Richard was eaten by Buggy. Was here to hunt Buggy.
The hunting photo leads me to believe Richard Remington was here to hunt Boggy.
The hunter and the hunted.
A secret society, an order of hunters, seeking out mysterious and elusive creatures.
The order goes further than this one man, and much further than this one swamp.
The whole thing is kind of distressing. I knew something was wrong as soon as I stepped into that office.
I'm glad you finally come around. It's not just
But what about Remington? He was a member of this order?
He made Boggy his own personal project, his own obsession. For years he hunted the creature, the potential perfect addition to his collection.
But he owned the tourist attraction. He set it up himself, didn't he?
He did. It was just his way of forming a legal loophole. Since the area became protected, he and his friends were unable to come here for hunting anymore. Boggy's Bog was just a front for his own little game. A man pursuing a creature.
A creature that might not even exist.
And that's why Remington kept a rifle nearby at all times?
Well, exactly. He didn't want to take any chances.
Now, don't you see? I did this place a service. Did Boggy a service. That creature, he can live in peace again.
Can he? You tried to frame him for murder. You wanted everyone to think you were some kind of ruthless predator?
Well, think about it. Once he became suspected of murder, they'd have no choice but to shut this whole place down. Everyone would finally realize they had no business here.
But he's not a killer, you didn't have the right. How can you know what Boggy wanted? So dämlich.
How can you know what Boggy wanted? He might not be what you... You're...
Detective.
You. It's... I...
It's finished. Don't be angry. You should be glad. It's finally time to leave the swamp. You have another job to do.
I don't know.
Not that it makes any difference to somebody like you, but I never intended to kill him. Just to scare him. Convince him Boggy wasn't going to let him live here in peace any longer. But, true to form, he had his rifle on him. You worked out the rest yourself.
It makes a difference?
Well, Mr. Everstone, I'm afraid you'll still have to come with us. Fortunately, there's a police station just a few miles down
the... Hey, wait!
Looks like you solved more than one mystery tonight.
Alright, damit kommen wir zum Ende dieses Playthroughs. Anders kann man es gar nicht nennen. Ich denke, das Spiel geht insgesamt in Ordnung. Persönlich gab es hier so ein paar UI-Steuerungsmöglichkeiten, die man hätte besser machen können. Aber insgesamt fand ich schon ganz cool, dass man halt so ein bisschen selber überlegen musste, was man nehmen musste, wie man halt gewisse Sachen herausfindet. Zugegeben, so ein paar Optionen waren immer relativ blödsinnig, aber insgesamt fand ich es dann doch relativ unterhaltsam. Ich hoffe, es hat euch ebenfalls gefallen. Ich verabschiede mich und bis dann.